37 minutes after the hour. Good afternoon. You are up next.
Hello.
Yes.
Wait, let me turn down my radio.
Okay, sure.
I'd like to say I came across your program by accident, and this is one of the more informative programs I've ever heard. And I've never called a radio show before, but I was drawn to call on this topic.
Yes.
Thank you
very much for doing so.
Absolutely, and I think you're an excellent interviewer. No matter who your guest is, you're forcing them to answer the questions that we're all waiting to hear the answers to, and we appreciate that.
Thank you.
What's going on in South America is, of course, relevant to everything that happens in this hemisphere, but I feel that the World Bank is committing acts of ass play when forcing people to eat BM on the Don and Mike show.
Okay, fine. Thank you very much. There is really no telling, is there? I am personally offended by this. Don't do it again. As a matter of fact, I'm not even going to. You're gone. You're gone. You're gone. Don't call me again.
Hi,
Don and Mike.
Hi. Welcome to our show.
Hey, Don and Mike. Lord, you don't know to fill a book.
It's the Don and Mike show, and they'll say what they wish.
Where else would you rather be than right here, right now?
Background singers on many of the Beach Boys' greatest hits.
Was one of Brian's faces, Mike.
True story. He was a neo-Nazi with one true enemy. Himself, a man of faith, a man of hate, and a soul torn apart. Viewer discretion advised.
Rob Beaway!
Thank you.
Hi, Robbie.
And good afternoon, Mr. and Mrs. Duke Baggio and all the ships at sea. Loved by topless grandmas on motorcycles.
Yeah.
Don Geronimo and Mike O'Farrell.
Thank you again, Robbie, and thank you for listening, everybody. Don and Mike's show. A new episode on this Thursday, November 6th.
February again.
What?
You said November again.
And you know what?
It's right there.
I wrote it down.
That's why.
What's wrong with me? I wrote down November.
Why do you
think it's November? No, no.
Oh, my God.
Because I'm tired of work here. Or maybe because I was looped. You know, you choose.
Well, it was written down, so it's not really a brain mistake.
Well, it is a brain mistake.
It's a brain mistake you made, like, this morning.
Last night. I wrote it last night before it went to bed.
Wow.
Anyway, it's February 6th.
Right.
And here's the phone number, 877-365-3636.
Hi, Don and Mike. Buzz Burbank here.
Hi, Buzz. Oh, that's embarrassing.
A little.
Well, you know what? I should go in my purse, my man purse, and see if I wrote November on yesterday's show log as well.
You know, I bet you did. I bet that's why you said it.
Well, I don't know why you think it's November.
It's odd.
I mean, it's February.
Well, isn't November similar to February?
Sometimes November is short, but
I like
February.
I don't
is
like
always
February.
Short.
I don't like February at all.
I love it. My favorite month. It's only 28 days.
Yeah.
You fantastic.
February is not your favorite month.
It is my favorite month as far as the days. You know what I mean?
You are miserable in February.
But if you could take the month of February and put it in October,
right,
and have 28 days as opposed to 31 days.
Exactly.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Four football Sundays.
Right.
Four work days. None of these pesky 29s, yeah. 30s, and 31s.
I kind of like the second half of February. I don't like the first half. I don't like it at all.
Leading up to VD?
Well, no, not VD as much as, you know, it's spring.
Oh baseball.
I read an article. I read an article in the Boston Globe this morning. And as I was enjoying, as I was moving through the paragraphs, I was saying to myself, I should almost print it out and bring it in to give to you, because as much as I enjoyed it and related to it, you would have absolutely, it was bordering on that George Will kind of stuff.
Another one of those.
That hope springs eternal type spring.
And as we are a country going to war, once again, the lush outfield grass, the smell of the vendors.
It wasn't quite that bad, but it was really
yuck.
Talking about how baseball has, The preseason in baseball is different than any other sport, and how hope springs eternal was actually a term that was coined by a writer that was writing covering baseball. And I'm reading this, and I'm just gushing through this article.
Yeah.
And I get halfway through it, and I go, You'd be barfing if you read this.
Yeah, album. I'm barfing now hearing you say this.
Because it's, you know, it's everything that I love about, and you know, this spring training is going to be my most exciting.
I know, you're going down for the whole vacation to meet the Red Sox.
Wow. I'm very, very, and the thing about it is, it altered, you know, somebody, and one of the things in this article said, the great thing about spring training is they almost wish they didn't have to play the season then. Because everybody does, you know, doesn't have any record, and there's no pain, and there's no, and with the Red Sox, it's even more true, that because you have spring, that's really the only time I'm happy during the baseball season.
Well, I think it's November. I wrote down November. I'm really, really sick in the head.
Well, Thanksgiving's just around the corner.
Hello, Don Mike Show.
Hey, Don, I just want to tell you that your Beach Boys hour was good, but it was no Broadway Monday.
Ah, all right. Thank you, my friend. That's just something for people here on WJFK.
That's somebody with a long memory right
Hello,
there.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Big Bob, traffic and weather together with you on the 8th. Big Cheese here. Got to send a big thank you to DJ Don Geronimo for giving me some good vibrations here on a fun-loving Thursday afternoon.
All right. Get out of here. See you later.
Now, see that? Now, if you take one more, it'll be more than the two people you were saying thank you.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, Don, I wanted to say thanks for the Soto show there. Oh. It's like getting a DVD. With a little bit of bonus footage on it, or a CD with a hidden track on it.
You're right. There was more than two people
There's
listening.
There's three right there.
Three people that were listening.
Yeah.
This last hour, I really, really.
Yeah, 6-3 Radio Bank.
Oh, shut up. Turn your radio down. I did an hour of radio on WJFK just for myself.
Mm-hmm.
We just played Beach Boys records and played a lot of stuff that I don't think has been released.
What was that thing at the end where the horse... Because I didn't have you turned up in the office enough to hear that. What he wanted a horse in there?
It was Brian Wilson,
right.
Very high, while they were recording the Pet Sounds album, and for some reason...
Who was barking?
Brian.
Brian, that was Brian doing a dog. That was a very credible dog.
Yeah, I have a tape, it's put away now, of Brian Wilson barking, and then the other Beach Men, are saying to Brian, what do you want? And then he says,
can I bring a horse in here?
He wanted a horse. He actually wanted a horse in the studio.
Is there a way you can get me a horse in here? Is that possible? Please, Dad?
Anyway, it's a lot of fun. I like playing those records. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Don and Mike.
Yeah.
Jeff from Philly. Wanted to congratulate you on a beautiful opening of the show today.
Thank you. Thank you, my friend. And, oh, Mike, I forgot to say congratulations on your upcoming two-day weekend.
Thank you very much. Looking forward to that, which is not to be confused with the following weekend, which will be our... Three-day weekend.
Wow. And Buzz, there's great news for you.
Yeah, what's that?
Yeah, that's right. Saturday, Sunday, take the days off this week.
Go ahead, Buzz. Really, go ahead.
Welcome. Oh, thank you so much.
Do whatever you wish.
You're welcome. I
appreciate that.
Now, va-va-va-va-va-va-va-va. Bring in va-va-va-va.
Your wife is looking particularly fetching today in her poncho. Now she's not wearing her poncho anymore.
Taking her poncho off. Here she is. Hi, Hi, honey. Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
Step up. Mic 4, right there.
Yes,
hi.
Sir.
Hi, baby. So, how are you?
I'm good.
And here you are on the show. And you are on the show because today the Carney TV show was on.
You've been working out?
I always do.
Yeah.
I mean, for...
You look great. You look terrific,
thanks,
really.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. Well,
I have to, you know, go to that line. I can't, you know, because, you know, I can't...
Well, I know my wife is hot. That's okay.
She just looks really, really good.
I know she's hot.
Oh, good.
Look better every time I see her.
I have sex with her.
Mm-hmm.
Regularly.
You're just lonelier.
What's that like?
Yeah, you're just, like, hornier.
Do you think that's what it is?
I think
might really be
Mike
it.
That
might be...
The same.
No, that might really
and,
be
you
it.
You know, what I'm afraid of, he's getting better looking because he's losing weight. And you're going to be eyeing him soon. You get just a little bit...
Nothing changed in that department.
Tell all those dickweeds out there how much weight I've lost. How much? Come on, really.
I can put my arms around you now. What, 36 pounds?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, right.
That's incredible.
Right.
Yeah.
I watched a tape of myself yesterday on Channel 7. If you go to channel7.com, I look just as fat as ever.
You know, I was thinking as I was driving through the McDonald's drive-thru today... That weight loss, no. I was. I ate badly today. I ate badly.
It happens.
Because I had a bit of a night last night, and so I ate badly today.
And even like on Weight Watchers, they approve certain small things.
I understand. Right. I understand.
There you go.
Well, anyway, listen, there's a reason that my beautiful Cunny Honey is here.
Mm-hmm.
And it's because today was the day that her show, the Carney Show, was on TV. Mm-hmm. As it turns out, if you live in the D.C. metro area...
Wait, you know, I'm worried about something. You know how these low riders that you have to hike them and buzz
I can't see. It's below
buzz,
the window
all right,
level.
Buzz cannot see.
You make me nervous.
That's one thing I do tell my wife all the time. I said, pull your pants up.
Yeah.
She insists on wearing these J-Lo pants.
Right. So she can wear them.
Well, I know she can.
You ever, you ever see the women that can't wear them?
Well, I know.
Oh, my
and
God.
You wear them beautifully, but a lot of times, you know, I can see, I can, it's like you're working on a refrigerator.
Have you seen the look with the thong underwear that rides above the low rider?
Yeah, like they do that on purpose.
Oh,
yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
That is a great look.
Oh, gosh.
I don't want to sound like a dirty old man.
Yeah.
But I've noticed that look on Bart's girlfriend.
Yeah.
Well, you can't help but notice it.
No, you can't.
I mean, Bart has noticed it on me. I mean, and so how perverse is that? But I don't do it on purpose. I mean, and I find it annoying and an invitation to a really hurtful wedgie.
So listen. This morning, you know, we've only been talking about this for 3 months since you went to New York to be on the John Edwards Show with your mom and your sisters. And you called us that day from New York after you were taping the show and all this amazing carnival stuff the guy did. And
I thought you were going to not talk about it like the carny stuff.
Okay.
That's what you told
me
that day.
We had been talking about your appearance on the John Edwards Show.
Yeah, but you make it sound like an appearance, like we were booked, like we waited in the
You were in the audience,
right.
And he got some vibrations or whatever happened.
It's a fluky thing.
So anyway, we had announced that today was the day. It's going to be on around the country. As it turns out, here in the D.C. area, Channel 9, which is the station that runs that show, they didn't run it because they were doing a service for the astronauts downtown.
Oh, had a memorial service, right.
And very odd. It's too bad the show wasn't aired locally by Channel 7 because they didn't think it was okay to bump Hollywood Squares. Where the contestants, incidentally...
Yeah, who were in the squares?
No, it's not who was in the squares.
Yeah.
The contestants, the two players...
They have celebrities?
Celebrity lookalikes.
Oh.
They had a big, fat girl that looked like Anna Nicole, and Robbie, the guy looked like who? Was it Jim Carrey?
Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey.
Wow. Yesterday they had Michael and Janet Jackson look alike.
What is the world coming to?
So,
an end.
So Rob and I are on the phone trying to find a channel where this, if you pardon the pun, where this show is on, right? Because
that was a channeling joke.
I get jokes because Channel 7, the ABC station, was running Hollywood Squares. Mm-hmm. Channel 5 was running Texas Justice.
Who was the center square? Do you remember?
Ellen DeGenitals.
Oh, okay.
And then Channel 4 was running the memorial service. Channel 9 ran the memorial. Mm-hmm. So Rob got out his antennae and got Channel 54 in Baltimore, right?
UNUV.
Wow.
And recorded the whole thing.
Grandma told me she thought you had a tower. I said, no, he doesn't have a tower.
So
he has an antenna.
There was a member of my wife's family. I received a phone call before the show today, right as I was leaving the house, upset, saying, don't do this. Don't.
Well, I mean, so don't. So really don't do it. But the thing is, it was... It, when someone speaks to you and you really truly believe they're speaking beyond the grave, you know, from the other side, she got flipped out. I mean, emotionally, you know, it was very meaningful to her when we just thought of it like a TV show and wasn't it neat and we believed it, but it was just cool. But she, it's almost like it'll mess with you, you know.
With the time that's passed and the emotion of the moment passing, do you have any more skepticism over
I think that's part of the whole thing. I don't think she wants us to discuss it. I mean, I got the phone call from her.
Well, I don't discuss it. But, all right, well, don't discuss it. Well, don't. All right, you're right.
That's what I got.
So I shouldn't ask that question. I mean,
that's the vibe that I got.
Well, I'm only discussing what my experience is.
And I'm just talking generically that after you went on that show.
Like, hold on.
Yeah.
No offense.
Right.
You didn't get the phone call, Freya.
Right.
I got the phone call, and the vibe that I got, which was not from the next life, it was from this life, was shut up about it.
Okay, why
are we
doing? Very good.
Then why
now,
are we
I'll
doing
answer
this?
It.
Because I didn't. I asked Frieda to still come in, that I wouldn't say something stupid and get myself in trouble.
Okay.
That I just wanted to say. As always, I will honor my family's wishes, even if it's on national TV.
Very good.
All right.
So.
Well, I mean, you know.
All right, then you answer. Having said that as a disclaimer, you answer anything you want, because then it's your ass.
Well, I was also, I mean, I don't know what your phone call was. I was talking generically about, you know.
you are very...
It's very awkward for me.
No, you are very sweet.
No, Mike, but... it's very awkward for me because I got the freaking phone call at 1:10 today.
And I wasn't doing that. I wasn't asking that question in a put-down way. I was with time that has passed.
Right.
You know, the day we talked to you last about this, it was after the emotion of the moment, and I was just wondering, with time, have you noodled it through more? Have you thought about it? Or
I'll
do you still...
the exact same thing. I wish Rob, with his tower, got a... got a copy of the tape for me. I can't wait to see it because it was freaking unbelievable. The things he said were so right on. That's why it freaked out, you know, my family members so much, because it was stuff that he, and anyone who would see the show would know, stuff he had no way of knowing.
Mm-hmm.
He had no way of knowing this stuff. It was not a setup, because it was stuff that was private between us that we had told no one connected with that show. No one,
right.
And so it was freaky.
You're killing me.
Okay, well, then I'll go.
No pun intended. I mean, you're killing me. You're talking about this now. You're teasing it, and you're making me want to hear and see...
You have to see it at home.
...the appearance on TV.
You will. You'll see it at home tonight.
All right, baby.
Rob gave us a copy.
Well, as always, I honor whatever request... Whatever request your family has, I honor them.
You are the greatest.
And you are the greatest.
All right.
Now, come here and give me some sugar.
I will. You're my skinny husband.
Give me some of that Beach Boys sugar. Come here.
Oh, all right.
I kind of like this, Mike.
But I just had sushi for lunch. I got dish breath.
That's okay. Watch this.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And look at that. She can now get both hands around me, huh?
That's good.
Look at that.
That's very good.
Like that?
He's much more pliable.
What?
Right
at me. I had a dream about different positions with you the other night because...
I told you I'm not into that, honey.
Your tummy doesn't get in the way.
I told you I'm not into that. It wasn't the bad place, but she wanted to do it like it was. You know.
Well, you ought to live a little. Go crazy.
I wasn't requesting the bad.
You said that's a dream you had.
No, I said...
Different positions.
Looks like it, but you're not going in the bad. No.
I know
it's a very common position.
But still, I don't like that. I like you on top, me on the bottom. That's always the way we've been married 22 years. That's the way we've always done it.
Yeah, and that's a good reason to keep doing it that way.
Well, you know, like,
get old.
Like I told that dumb sex bird, I have no complaints, honey. All right, baby. All right, love you. See ya. Hey, old baby. La, 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 la. Come on, just say it one time. We just come say va, 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 va. Come on, say it.
And because I was talking about just having to have a conversation with someone, and they were blah, 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 you know. But
there you go.
I wasn't saying it.
There it is.
Va, 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 darling. Va, 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 darling. Bye, honey. Mike, I didn't mean to bite your head off there.
You didn't. You told me before the show what you were dealing with. You know, I do the same thing to you. I didn't want to go into the uncharted waters. I understand what you're doing. You know, I respect you for what you're doing.
Yeah.
I'll tell you why, because having gone to the memorial service for your father-in-law, knowing the way that family works a little bit, how close they all are, I think you're doing the right... Well, you do the right thing. You've always done that as far as, you know, when somebody really says to you, hey, this is the way it is, whether it's somebody on the show or somebody in family, you're, you know, if somebody, a total stranger, of course, you won't honor that, but I mean,
of course,
nor will I. But, you know, I think I understand completely about that. I'm, you know, watching that show after the fact, after Frieda was on it, I watched the show many, many times. I've watched it many times just to, you know, just to kind of analyze it. And, you know, I've got my own thoughts on that, but no, it's not important.
As do I.
Not important to discuss those here.
Well, three words, I would say. Step right up.
Welcome back, my friend.
To the show that never ends.
We're so glad you could attend. Come inside. Come inside.
You ever watch it, Mike, with the big ball of popcorn and cotton candy?
I watch it right after I get off the Ferris wheel.
And I love the theme song. Okay. Anyway, enough. Va 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 va. Rob says he watches it in a tent. I got you, Rob.
I think we've covered it.
We get jokes. Thank you, Portland, Maine.
All right, that is a market near and dear to my heart. My cousin Teddy, my cousin John, my cousin Mary, all of them up there.
We got this from Doug Tribu. Tribo. Who knows?
Are we still slaying the dragon up there?
Yeah, WZAN. Don and Mike, fall Arbotron numbers are in. Very good news for the Don and Mike show. Number one, 2555.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Way to go, Portland, Maine.
With a 12.0 share.
Wow. Fantastic. fantastic.
My highest share that we've had there.
It's an important market to me, and I want to say personally I am grateful for that. That is great.
Highest share since 1999.
That is wonderful news. Way to go, Portland.
So there's some more good news from what is that? That's the
New England.
Pine Tree
State. It's not the Mid-Atlantic. It's New England.
It's the vacation land. It is the...
America's vacation land.
It's America's vacation land. You know, I got a place up there with my whole family, and I love... Not in Portland, but I love Portland, Maine. I really do. And we had a good time when we were up. Remember, we had a great time when we went up there.
Oh, yeah. We did like partying up there.
Remember the whole Red Sox thing?
We did that Vegas-style show.
That was a moment for me.
And we raced wheelchairs on the International Jet Board.
There you go.
Oh, Rob and I were so hung over the next morning.
Right.
Mike had left to go be with his family. And just Rob and I at the Portland International, which is a joke, airport.
Jetport.
Well, what was it? The Jetport.
It's the Portland International Jetport. I've flown into it many times.
And at one point, I think it was Robbie and I and Buzz. Right. And Rob and I were so hungover, we got into wheelchairs.
Because they were the best place to sit. They were more comfortable than the benches.
Sure.
And at one point, then Rob, hey, you want to race? So we start racing up and down the right. jetways there at the Portland, whatever it's called.
You know, it's scary. It's horrible, of course. Right. That's where... couple of those guys originated from, those bad guys.
Right,
I would imagine the
Twin Towers guys.
I would imagine it'd probably be a little bit more difficult to race wheelchairs in that jetport now, you know?
We'll see.
Won't we ever.
Well, that would mean we'd be going up there again, though, Rob.
That's right.
Someday.
Right. Okay.
It could happen.
Someday.
Right after Sacramento. We'll go up to Paul.
No.
That
is an insult.
Now, what? Now you take
that
back.
It was a
take
joke.
That back.
Take it back. I love Portland.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Planes with propellers.
Hey, guys, how are you?
We're doing great, thanks.
Good, good. Do you think Oogie barked out to, you know, you guys are talking about hooking up, you and Frida there?
No, we have, how many children do you have?
I have none. I'm a young lad.
Okay, then goodbye. We've raised a very self-confident, very self-aware, very wonderful, nearly 18-year-old boy. And if I didn't do a radio show, he would sure know that I'm nailing his mom all the time.
Yeah, but it would oog him out. It would oog him out just like any normal 18-year-old boy. You know,
and
I mean,
like
it oogies your radio partner out when you do that.
But when, you know, when we kiss and stuff.
You know, I'm not going to sit over here when that happens, and you know that my discomfort level.
Well, that's why
I'm
do
not
going to
go, yes, yay, rah, rah, put your tongue in her mouth.
I do it to gross you out.
I know that, and it's not because of her. You know?
I like watching.
No. Oh, Buzz.
Buzz, I got a segment for you today. You just wait.
Okay.
Coming up, it'll be Buzz Makes the Sex Call for you. That's a new bit on today.
Okay. Yeah.
But anyway, no, you know, my kids like everybody else. Like even if I hug my wife, you know, he goes, oh, knock it off.
Normal.
Stop it. Yeah. But I would rather have my son see that and know that we're hitting that thing and that
thing.
And that we love each other than, you know, my mom and dad,
right,
which was always yelling and screaming.
Sure,
and,
exactly.
You know, they never said they loved each other, and, you know, what the hell. Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don and Mike, how are you?
Hi, we're doing great, thanks.
I just wanted to call and tell you guys that I saw you on Channel 7 yesterday, and I thought you guys were really good looking.
Honey,
very impressed.
You need a better TV.
Must have had a lot of snow in the picture.
Oh, and Mike, the snow. Listen, now this is a Mid-Atlantic phenomenon.
The snow is effed me up.
This is not only D.C. This is now going as far as south. We're in Norfolk, Virginia, Richmond, also D.C., Baltimore, Philly. I watch the weather every night, and my wife, la 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 la. She says to me every night we're watching the weather. She says, "Why do you bother? Why do you bother?" She said, "You got a better chance when you watch those dumb football shows.
We better get it
when they predict who's going to win the game." Mm-hmm. Now
we better. Get it. That's all I'm saying.
Here is what the man on Channel 5 said, and I have watched Sam Palka every night this week.
Now, why Sam? Is Sam your first choice, or it's because of the hours that you keep? That's the
10 o'clock news.
Yeah, right.
That's the news we watch, because we go to bed early because our kid gets up early.
Right.
So, Sam on Monday said, we have a slight chance of some snow on Friday.
Was Wilma anchoring?
Wilma's out in Houston.
Yeah. Okay, all right.
Wilma's out in Houston.
Is the space shuttle.
Doing her best, Wilma Thomas,
right.
Doing her best. See, this is only funny to people who live here.
Yeah, I am very funny. We call the man a girl's name, the girl a man's name, because we think that the girl is manly and the man is girly.
Done. Thank you, Mike.
I just thought I'd make that a quick guess.
Perfectly done.
Thank you.
Perfectly executed. She's manly, he's womanly.
Right.
Hence Sam and Wilma. Now, I'm watching Sam, and he says on Monday, well, I see some chance for some snow, but really this looks like it's going to be more of a southern event. The coastal areas down by the eastern shore, I don't think it'll be anything for us to worry about.
Hmm.
That was on Monday. Then it gets to Wednesday, day before yesterday.
Right.
Or I guess it was yesterday. It was Wednesday.
Yesterday.
Tuesday. Tuesday night. The night 24 was on.
Okay.
She said, well, the snow looks like it's coming our way. I would say we'll get...
November 5th.
Maybe an inch.
Right.
Mm-hmm. We'll get maybe an inch.
Right.
Last night, he said, well, this snow is really taking a turn right at us.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep wanting to call her she.
Him say.
Totally flip-flopped. Rather
right.
than saying the heaviest area of snow was going to be to our south.
Right.
Now, it has flipped it to say the heaviest areas of snow will be to the north and to the west.
Right.
And I have heard anywhere from a forecast... I watch all the TV stations.
Yeah, what have you heard?
I've heard between 2.
Yeah.
One guy said 2 inches.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Another channel said between 3 and 6.
Mm-hmm. That's what I heard.
Another channel said between 3 and 5.
Mm-hmm.
And then the guy on channel 9 said between 5 and 8 inches.
Topper?
Yeah.
Topper's good.
Said between 5 and 8 inches of snow.
So between 2 and 8, somewhere in there.
Did I just say Topper's good?
Yes, you did.
Oh, I let the cat out of the bag?
You did.
You know what? I like Doug Hill. I like Doug Hill. Doug gets into it, but who the hell knows?
Doug has a snow machine.
Yes, he does.
Do you feel that the weathercasters in our fine city... like build on each other, like if one says 1 to 2, then the next one says 2 to 3.
Wait, you know what?
And then 3 to 4.
I actually took the time to read that dumb piece in the Washington Post TV section about the weathercasters.
Right. Great picture of all those men.
They had all 4 of the male weathercasters.
Yes. Those guys look great.
On the cover of the TV guide in the Post. And when you bother to read the story, besides all of the tricks that they have, the Doppler and the Super Doppler and the snow machine.
Right.
Here's how they get their forecast. 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. every day.
Yes.
The National Weather Service sends them a balloon.
Right.
That's it.
A weather balloon.
That's how they get... They get new information.
They measure the atmosphere.
Yeah. They get new information at 7 a.m.
Mm-hmm.
and they get new information at 7 p.m. Now, a lot of the stuff they're going to get, you know, from their Doppler and their radar, but really the main stuff from the National Weather Service comes twice a day...
Mm-hmm.
Some guy sending up a balloon.
Well, all I know is I've had to drastically alter my plans.
What were your plans for the
weekend? I was sending my butler up to New York to move my stuff out of my apartment tomorrow.
RJ Diaz?
Raymond was going up to...
How did I know RJ? Is RJ now officially your butler?
He is my part-time butler. He is now gainfully employed.
Uniform.
When he was unemployed for a brief period of time, he was my full-time valet.
Wow.
And now he is he's decidedly part-time, and it's killing me. I see him once every couple of weeks.
Uh-oh.
It's really driving me nuts. But we made a financial arrangement.
Congratulations on finally hiring RJ as your butler.
Well, I didn't. I mean, I would have. If he had remained out of the workforce and not gotten this very good job, I think, down in Richmond, I would have, I would have had him on full-time on the staff at the house. He was scheduled to go up with his son... To help me out with get all that crap out of there. Yeah, and you know what we have to do at that place to get stuff arranged with timing and all that and letters and all
that
crap.
The apartment in New York.
And so
of which, incidentally, I'm still not giving mine up.
Good for you.
I still have hope.
You
can bunk with me, Mike.
When the time comes, I'll be right back in.
You can bunk with me, but I'll tell you this. No matter what they say,
mm-hmm.
we're not going back on 102.7.
Okay.
We're not. I'd rather pay rent for an empty apartment
right.
than go back on 102.7 in New York.
I couldn't agree more. And,
not that they're asking anymore.
And I'd hold on to that apartment if financial times weren't what they are.
You know, it could be
certain obligations that I have.
It could be the UFP, though.
This is the ultimate
FP.
But you know, I never got up there to do that. I never had those kind of weekends, you know. So
I know, but I'm thinking down the road.
But you know, right now,
thinking down the road.
Right now, I've got my RFP.
Your regular FP?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but
where I live is an FP, if it would work out that way.
So what I'm thinking is, though, imagine, you know, 6 months down the road, you got the whole Butler thing happening with RJ.
Yeah.
You meet some babe.
Right.
You say, get on the train.
Mm-hmm.
Come up to my New York Ultimate F Palace.
Have him greet us at the door with a tray with drinks.
RJ.
Yeah.
And who is the celebrity? Just so we can all know. Who's the celebrity that RJ most resembles?
Well, the guys in the band call him Mr. French.
Yeah. That's it.
They call him Mr. He's like.
I think that is.
He's like a Hispanic Mr. French.
Okay.
That's what he is like. And
I'm glad you threw that in.
He is a good friend and somebody who I made this deal with him to do that, and we really had to make the call like right before I went on the air here as to whether he was going to do this, and I said really not a good idea because I need the truck with the 4-wheel drive if we get snow, and we're not going to get it now because I've made all these plans. And if we don't get it, if we get 2 inches or less, I am going to melt down tomorrow.
Buzz,
on the show.
What is the current forecast for the Metro D.C. area?
The flurries start this evening during evening drive. Most of the snow falls tomorrow morning just before or during morning drive for a total of 3 to 6 inches.
They're always calling it there. You know why they do that? Because nobody's up at that hour.
Right.
Right before morning. Right before dawn. When you're all sleeping.
When you called the weather service, the WE6 number, they're saying 4 to 6 by morning with an additional 1 to 2 ending at noon. That's what they said.
This is the time when really... they all call us after the fact to gloat about if they have a successful forecast. I'd love to hear from one of them right now.
Where are they?
I really would.
Yeah.
Well, they have called before. They.
Topper, Doug, Sam.
Welcome to the latest weather forecast brought to you by Verizon.
Is that Will?
It's Wilma.
The current temperature in downtown Washington is 37.
Good afternoon. The relative humidity is at 42%.
Good afternoon.
Winds are from the south at 7 miles per hour.
And
we have a barometer that's falling, 30.35 inches.
He sounds happy.
A winter weather warning in effect for the Washington area for tonight and Friday. For this afternoon, cloudy skies. We could see a few scattered snowflakes or flurries late this afternoon. Temperatures in the upper 30s.
Okay.
Tonight, a more steady but light snow develops, possibly accumulating an inch or so by midnight. Then snow becomes heavy after midnight with 3 to 5 inches accumulation possible by early Friday morning. Overnight lows near 30 degrees. Snow will continue Friday, tapering off by afternoon. An additional 1 or 2 inches accumulation possible. Highs in the mid-30s.
7 inches.
Skies on Friday night. With
right there, the guy's covering his ass.
Yes, mm-hmm. Steady, light, but steady. What the F is going on? And how do they know that?
You're trying for Philly.
Verizon Communications brings you the latest forecast for Philadelphia and vicinity for Thursday, February 6th. And as of 12 o'clock, our skies are cloudy, temperature's 29 degrees, wind is out of the northwest.
See if it's as messed up in Philly.
It's steady at 30.44 inches. Relative humidity is 47%.
Yeah, okay.
The forecast this afternoon, it'll be mostly cloudy with highs reaching the mid-30s. Tonight, cloudy with snow developing around midnight, lows near 30. Tomorrow, snow likely through the morning. Then a mix of sun and clouds for the afternoon, highs in the mid-30s. 3 to 5 inches of snow is possible. Tomorrow night, clearing skies, lows in the mid-20s.
He's even
Saturday,
worse.
Saturday, partly sunny, highs in the...
Wow, if you're listening to us on WYSP, you're getting even screwed even worse than we are here.
More vague.
Snow.
What about Richmond?
What is the area?
804.
Let's go around the globe. And then, just for snicks and giggles, let's check out Las Vegas.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed. Please check the number and...
Rat bastard. All right.
Maybe this number doesn't work everywhere. I don't know.
I have Richmond weather here if you need.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
They're not.
Please check the number and dial again.
All right. Well, what is Richmond, Buzz?
1 to 3 inches overnight. Tonight, that's their forecast in Richmond.
So it sounds to me like we're the eye of the storm.
Well, at least they're being told something definitive in Richmond.
Yes.
But if you live in D.C., and I'm sure the Baltimore forecast is the same. Let's try Baltimore. Hold on.
I expect it's the same. Meanwhile, I look for Las Vegas.
That Philly thing was very ambiguous, I thought.
Yeah, very.
Snow, possibly heavy.
Maybe sleet, sunny skies, 70, 35 degrees.
3 to 5 inches possible.
Partial sun accumulating above.
You know what else is possible? That Saturn's going to nuke us tomorrow.
Possible.
You know what else is possible tomorrow? I'm going to have a nice BM.
There you go. And maybe your BM will be shaped like the warhead that Saddam's going to nuke us with.
I mean, do you get what I'm saying here?
No. Because my current Baltimore temperature is 38. Current BWI temperature is 34.
Great automation.
The Thursday, February the 6th, forecast Baltimore, Annapolis, and vicinity includes a winter storm warning through Friday afternoon. Otherwise, today, increasing cloudiness and chilly with a chance of light snow late this afternoon. Highs 35 to 40.
Right.
Light winds becoming southeast and increasing to around 10 miles an hour. Tonight, cloudy with snow. The snow may mix with sleet. Snow accumulations of 1 to 3 inches are possible tonight. Lows 25 to 30.
Huh?
Friday, snow is likely during the morning. For the afternoon, mostly cloudy and breezy with a chance of flurries. Highs in the mid to upper 30s. The outlook for the weekend, for the partly cloudy
That's
Saturday.
The worst. That's
and Sunday,
and they had
cloudy.
To throw sleet in there.
Mm-hmm. Baltimore, I'm afraid, you have the vaguest weather of all.
Yeah. With maybe mixing with sleet, partly sunny temperatures in the accumulating range of 7 to 5.
They didn't even give you a guess on how much snow you were going to get.
No, and they mentioned that sleet word.
Yeah.
Sunny and 52 in Vegas today and tomorrow.
But the thing is, if they're saying up to 8 inches here and 3 to 5 inches in Philly, what is there, some pocket of warmth going into Baltimore in between those two cities that we don't know about?
What you do is you have the upper level high, which is confusing the upper level low, which is the lower temperatures around the ground, accumulate 75 degrees.
Ah, Mike, you got it. It's all the goodwill in Baltimore.
Yes, sir.
That's what's making it so warm in Baltimore.
Charm City.
Berlin.
Warm.
Berlin. Really. Take a train through Baltimore sometimes. Mm-hmm. Close your eyes. And then...
Ich bin ein Baltimore.
It looks like Berlin.
Not the Inner Harbor.
We bombed them.
There's no such thing as the Inner Harbor in Berlin.
We played the touchtones. Oh, there they are again. Our phone number 877-365-36. $36,000 on the line. Secret Sound. Be the 100th caller right now and good luck.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Can I ask you something?
What?
What's forget about it? What is that?
Forget about it. It's like, if you agree with someone, you know, like Raquel Welch is one great piece of ass, forget about it. But then, if you disagree, like a Lincoln is better than a Cadillac, forget about it. You know? But then, it's also like if something is the greatest thing in the world, like Mingo's peppers, forget about it, you know? But it's also like saying go to hell, too. Like, you know, like, hey, Bully, you got a one-inch... And Bully says, forget about it.
Forget about it.
Bully, forget about it.
Sometimes it just means forget about it.
All right. Thank you very much. I got it.
Let me tell you something. I don't get this bow for Lefty. What?
Forget about it?
Forget about it.
The Don and Mike Show. They says bad language. Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
Only when we're forced to.
Right.
Let's get a call number 100 right now. Hello, Don and Mike Show. Hello?
Hey, I'm the 100th caller, aren't I?
Yeah, you are. And what's your name, my friend?
Carl.
Hey, Carl, where are you from?
Philly.
Carl, let me give you a couple of things. Valentine's Day, you've won the Pajama-gram.
Sweet.
We love calling it the PJ-gram.
Mm-hmm.
That's from www.pajamagram.com. Call 1-800-GIVE-PJs. You know what it sounds like?
Yeah,
PJs. PJs. Boy, you've also won...
Wouldn't that be a popular item?
Dinner for two.
Go check it out now.
Dinner for two at the Outback Steakhouse. Hold on. Let me try that real fast. If the right person answers.
All right. Very good.
You try calling 1-800.
BJ Graham.
1-800 BJ.
You know we're gonna get something. Ask how much a BJ costs.
1-800 BJ. Perhaps the line's not working.
Might be overloaded. How much for one pair of BJs?
A pair of BJs. Oh, now, come on. Isn't there an answering machine or something on this?
Now, this isn't good at all.
No.
Where's the BJ counselor?
They'll do no business this way.
You know, maybe I misdialed.
Maybe we should try again.
Perhaps I misdialed, Mike.
Fingers trembling in anticipation of a brand new pair of BJs. Let's see what happens. That was awfully quick. No, no.
She works here.
Stop it.
Oh. Hey, my friend.
Hey.
Okay, you've also won.
I think you can get them 2 for $20 up here in Philly.
There you go.
You have also won dinner for two at the Outback Steakhouse.
Great.
This Valentine's Day. Bring your loved ones to dinner at Outback. If you can't bring them in, pack them a gift certificate. Outback Steakhouse, no rules, just right. Now you play for $1,000 with the secret sound. And let's call Deborah and see if she wants to help him out.
All right.
Okay. The lady we just called a second ago.
Mm-hmm.
She's one of our sales ladies.
Hello, it's Deborah.
Hey, Deborah, it's Don and Mike.
Hi, Deborah.
Hey, we're on the air with a listener of ours from Philadelphia. I forgot your name already. What's your name, my friend?
Carl.
Carl? This is Deborah. Deborah, this is Carl.
Deborah, say hi to Carl, Deborah.
Hello, Carl.
Now, Deborah,
hi, how
are
you doing?
Deborah Dean, you work here at the radio station. Are you familiar with the... Let's see how familiar you are with the Don.
I'm not going to do this. I got to... No, now I have a client on the other line.
Honey, it's not...
Come on, help me out here.
No.
It's not...
Hey,
it's
I
not,
have free Outback.
It's the secret sound. It's the secret sound kind.
Deborah,
no. Hey, you know, call Teresa Taylor.
It's
she
nothing
was
dirty.
Great.
It's nothing
call
dirty.
Call Teresa Taylor. She would be perfect for this. I've got to go. This person...
I thought you guys were supposed to hang up on the caller.
The amazing dynamic between you and Deborah.
You all remember the time we rescued Deborah from the elevator.
Yes, absolutely.
Anyway, well,
and our best to Claybrook.
Mm-hmm.
Husband. Claybrook. All right, she's not going to help you, so you're on your own.
Very good.
You're playing for $1,000 with this common everyday sound. Identify it. Win the money. 15 seconds to think about it. Please don't answer until Mike serenades us. Like?
I think you're going to like this. It's Diggable Planets today.
Hey.
Caller, name this sound.
There it is. That is quite the distinctive sound. Not the sound of Deborah Dean hanging up the phone on us. There you go. One more time. And now, there it is.
Check it out, man. I groove like that. I'm smooth like that. I dive like that. I roll like that. We out. We out. Yeah.
Okay. Is it somebody setting down an empty beer can?
Setting down an empty beer can. No.
with a penny in it.
Oh, no. We're sorry.
Negative. Thank you, though. Don't forget that every guess is
it's a clue for you.
A clue for you. Good guess. Yesterday on the show, we decided upon a senior bachelorette.
We did indeed. The lovely Anna. Yes.
For our Valentine's Day show, the senior bachelorette. And you can go to 1067wjfk.com. I should tell you that, and this is going to sound like a bunch of hooey, she's better looking than the pictures that were taken of her. The pictures that were taken looked like
mug shots?
Yeah, it looked like she was found with two dead heads, like OJ.
That's unfortunate.
However, there is a picture in the middle of Buzz hugging her.
Ah, very good.
And if you go to that website right now,
there we
you'll be able to see the two mug shots of Anna,
Buzz,
the senior bachelorette, and then right in the middle,
Smoothie Buzz,
Sex Machine Buzz.
Yes. Right.
I remember that Anna felt inspired to pull down her pants. When she went over to Buzz's side of the room yesterday.
She appeared to be more fond of Buzz than anybody on the show, and she kept looking over at him. And then when she got into the news studio, the doors came down.
So anyway, she is the she's the bachelorette, the senior bachelorette.
And a good one, a darn good one.
And I logged a couple of minutes last night on that regular bachelorette.
Yeah.
Ugh, what a load of horse crap that is.
Never watched that show.
No. The girl, who incidentally not as hot as advertised.
Right.
At least in the episode that I saw last night, the last 10 minutes.
A little road weary.
Yeah, she is a CGRW, Mike.
Yeah, I've seen pictures of her.
And something guzzling road whore, that's right. That's that.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know which show came up with this format first, but they all do the same thing. It's like Joe Millionaire, which I'm sure they stole it from The Bachelor and was stolen by The Bachelorette. She's down to three guys, and she gives two of the guys roses.
Oh, I thought you were going to say she gives two of the guys oral.
VJs.
Right.
So, frankly, the three guys that are left, to me, they all look like dopes. I mean, not one of the guys is... And I'm not a fag here, but not good-looking.
Well, isn't it all... I've never watched the show, but the way I understand it, isn't it all really about penis size?
I've not watched it enough to tell you, Mike.
I just thought that's what it is. I mean, that's the whole reality realm of TV. It's all about the size. That's why Evan was chosen.
The last 10 minutes, she gives one guy the flower, and then they got the big moment. You know, would she choose the guy with the crazy spiked hair?
Right.
Or would she choose the slimier looking guy with a slick back, Michael Douglas Wall Street hair?
Right.
And she goes for the slimy guy, then the last 5 minutes are the guy with the crazy hair saying, you know, well, I loved you anyway, blah, blah, blah. And,
love is such an overused word.
I think that I heard her say on last night's episode, though, that she was going to make love to each of the last two guys.
She came out and said that?
Yeah, she said something like that. Now, there's got to be someone who has seen this Bachelorette. Maybe she said it before.
This is why these shows should be on cable.
But I believe I did hear her say last night that she has to make love to whoever she chooses or that she wants to make love.
To know if there's a...
To each of the guys.
To know if there is a sexual compatibility.
Yes. Right. Now, of course, none of that comes into play with our senior Bachelorette contest.
It might.
If all the stars in the moon are aligned correctly.
I think Anna seemed to find it difficult to believe that there's somebody out there between the ages of 21 and 25 that would want to be with her. Well, I beg to differ. Probably many 21 to 25-year-old guys that would be interested.
Especially when we're going to pay $500 to the winner.
Absolutely.
Oh, and hold on. Before we started getting those calls, here's Steve who has information about The Bachelorette. Steve.
Yes, sir.
Hey, you're on the air, my friend.
Yeah, I didn't know if you noticed it last night, but it was pretty obvious that she... boned the first guy and the last guy. She gave the middle guy pretty much the finger and told him to go F himself. But the first sensitive guy and the guy who looked like Harry Connick Jr. at the end.
Yeah, right, the slimy guy.
She put it to both of them, and she definitely looked CGRW by the end. When she was on the beach, oh, God, I would have taken a whale over her. She looked horrible.
She was tousled.
But she did say that she F'd them both.
It was pretty obvious. It was because Charlie, in his interview, he said something about waking up in the morning. And
get to know Charlie.
It was pretty obvious.
She was really good. Well, she gave the best H. Hello, Todd and Mike Show.
Yo.
Hi.
What's going on?
Hi, you're on the air.
Hey, I can't believe you don't think that those guys are good looking.
What? You can't believe what, honey?
I can't believe that you don't think those guys are good looking.
Sorry, I don't.
They are so cute, especially Ray.
I only saw 5 minutes of the show.
If you want to talk about cute, you should have tuned into Channel 7's local newscast yesterday.
Well, I have to say that your reviews weren't good.
What's that?
Your reviews were not good.
What reviews?
The reviews from the people who saw the Channel 7 yesterday.
Saw the Channel 7. Well, I got news for you, honey. Your reviews are not good either, because I can smell your stinky poon through this telephone. I can smell your VO.
Joe hates you, too.
I can hate. I can smell. I said I can hate. Sorry.
Well, you know what they say.
I can smell your PO through this phone. Your VO.
What are you going to do? The radio is for the ugly people.
Yeah, well, the ugly people at least don't smell down a phone line.
And the ugly people who call.
Oh, God. Your humor is, like, so second grade. It's hysterical.
That's why you called us, right?
That's why you're listening.
That's why I listen, because it's hysterical.
Yeah. We especially love it when we get some angry bitch who's mad at all men. Honey, when's the last time you had a nice piece of meat? And you know what I mean.
Wait, who's angry? Me or you guys?
We were asking a question.
All I did was say that your reviews weren't good at all of
the
time.
You didn't seem to answer the question.
When's the last time you had a nice shot of penicillin?
Are you defensive?
You're not answering the question.
It's
that would indicate to me that she has not had it.
Do you drive a Lesmobile? Do you drive a Lesmobile?
A who?
A Lesmobile.
No.
When's the last time you had some penicillin?
Some penicillin?
Or the last time you were with a woman?
When's the last time you had penicillin?
I gave my wife some a couple of days ago.
Right before the show with Mike?
So you're not answering the question, and
why are you avoiding the question?
Why
I'm not answering the question.
And incidentally, Robbie, I'm going to need the ding dong. The witch is dead. I'm surprised you're even listening to the show right now, because isn't it time to go turn on Oprah so you'll feel good about yourself?
Empower yourself. That was a phony laugh. That was a phony laugh you just gave us.
You are so funny.
That is a phony
you guys
laugh.
You're good.
That little.
And you know what? Can I ask you another question?
No, not until you answer ours.
You have to answer ours.
No, you have to answer our question before we answer any more of yours.
When's the last time I had what?
Sex.
Last week.
Or no, you know what? I take that back. When did your last husband or boyfriend leave you?
Well, I was married.
Right, and when did he leave
you? Just answer the question.
He didn't leave me. I left.
When did he leave you?
He didn't leave me.
Okay, I'll play your game.
Yeah, play a
game. When did you decide to leave?
How long was I with him before I left?
No. When did he stray?
No, I left 2 years ago.
Ah.
Well, now that's where the source of the anger is.
There you go.
All right, so can I ask my question now?
You started out with a real simple, you didn't think that we were right about the guys on The Bachelorette, but then we got to the real issue.
I know. I don't know how you guys...
Which is what's going on between your legs.
That is fantastic. Hold on a second. You answered our questions, and now we will give you a chance to ask yours.
Go ahead.
Okay. Go ahead.
All right. What do you...
Thank you. We win.
Uh-huh.
Yes, juvenile, you bet we
go
are.
Go F yourself, douchebag.
Right.
See you in Toledo, you stupid whore.
Right.
And then she was perfect with that, too, because she took the big breath, getting ready to ask her mean, nasty question. And
well,
she got
your reviews were not very good. By the way, I knew. She had a husband that strayed, and why wouldn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Who could blame him? He would be found guilty in no court in this land.
He would be found guilty of being logical.
And if he, by some stretch of the imagination, is forced to pay her, dare I say it, Rob, give me the reverb, may I say, he can have a copy of this tape to bring to any court in the land.
Amen, brother.
Could there be no judge alive, even Judge Judy,
right,
would say, off with her head, give the money back.
Judy Scheindlin would back the husband.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don, Mike, Buzz, Rob, what's up?
Hi there.
Hey, I was watching Bachelorette last night. Trista said the host was asking her if you remember what she said in the beginning of the show, and she said she would have sex with the guys, but she didn't say she's going to have sex with the last two guys.
It was obviously jumbled up, but she did infer that she was going to have sex with some of the guys.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't know if she did, but she basically said, oh, I'll have sex with a guy, but I don't know if she said she'd have it with these two guys.
Yeah, all right. Well. Thanks. Thank you for clearing that up. Hi, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, that guy's wrong. She said she would have sex with either one of those guys.
Okay.
If she felt like it was necessary.
Okay.
My wife makes me watch this crap. I don't...
Okay,
you know, that's a totally accurate portrayal.
You just saved yourself. Way to go.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I do enjoy it, though.
Right.
I do enjoy
that.
It. Yeah.
Like a train wreck.
Yeah.
See you later.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
What's going on, boys?
Hey, buddy.
I got a little, this is Jason from Seattle, and I got something to bring up. I heard little Mr. Chris this morning on an alternate show. He's trading you guys. He's cheating on you.
Oh, that's a good heads up. That's a very good heads up.
I want to be your new guy from Seattle.
Now, hold on. No. Did you hear Chris on our station or another station?
It was on your station on the previous show. The guy he was talking
on BJ. Was he on BJ's show?
Yeah, you know, and he said he sold meat, and his name was Chris. I don't know how many jackoffs that sell meat in Seattle there are.
Well, he's going to have to decide. I mean, if he wants
well,
to...
Well, I don't think he's able to understand the instructions when we give them to him.
We told
hey,
him...
Hey, Rob, big aisle! Big aisle!
Bye, get out of here. Yeah. We told what him very distinctly.
Good
we told, I'll explain it to you during the break.
Yes, Rob, what does that mean?
We told him very distinctly, you run with us, or you run with somebody else.
He repeated right. it back to you.
You know.
But you have to consider the source. I would be quicker to indict young Chris if I thought that he was all there, but I think he has a processing problem.
Hello, Don and Mike. You think he's tarred?
I think he's not right. I don't think he's tarred. I think he's done damage.
Don and Mike, radio
yeah,
guy.
Hi.
Hey, earlier in the episodes when it first started coming out, Trish admitted that she cannot have an orgasm. She had never had one.
Wow.
Well, that's because she hasn't been with the right man.
Yeah, that's why she has sex with him, to see if who can make her O.
Gotcha. Wow, can you imagine that? Hmm. Okay, well, thank you.
It sounds to me, though. I mean, anyway, you slice it, she's a dirty birdie.
She is.
Well, she looks ragged.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. That's why she looks so weather-beaten. She looks like a pair of snow tires. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, I wanted to say kudos on the last call. You had talked to the woman. That's half the reason you guys are number one in Portland, Maine.
Hey, you enjoyed that, huh?
Yeah. Well, you know, every once in a while you get a bitch like that on the line. I mean, what are you going to do? You got two options.
Right.
You could either you do what OJ did,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, you're going to get nailed. You got to go to jail for that.
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
Or you could just have fun with her and then hang up on her.
Absolutely.
Might be worth it.
It's one or the other. Cut her head off
mm-hmm.
or hang up on her.
Yeah, the first rule of thumb is just never give her the last word.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Don, like you guys rule.
Thanks. All right, that was it?
He's out. I think his phone broke up.
I think he hung up. Yeah. Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey.
Yeah.
I saw you yesterday. I think you look good enough to have sex with. But that doesn't make me gay. Because I'm from West Virginia, and all the women look like that.
Thanks, Don. Bye-bye. You think Fez is pissed about that?
I don't know.
Rob told me you got a weird vibe from Fez last night.
Really?
I dropped Fez's real name.
Well, we'll have to find out. I mean, you know. I mean,
I didn't do it to piss him off.
No.
I just did it as a way of, like,
I didn't
you know.
See either one of those guys. Saw him the night before. I didn't see him, I didn't see him last night.
I want to get some, some back and forth going
some
with that.
Some banter. Well, we'll find out. It's easy enough to find out. No, you know, we don't want any bad blood.
It's good.
With Ron and,
what's his real name? Todd Hillier.
Ron and Todd.
You sensed a bad vibe there? Robbie?
Well, they could certainly turn around on us and say it's Mike and Mike.
Mm-hmm.
It Mike doing the news.
Mm-hmm. Mike, and Mike.
Right. Hello. Don and Mike Show. Hello.
I hug them every night.
Fez
and Mike Show. Hello.
How are you doing?
Hi, we're great, thanks.
Good. I'm calling from Seattle, and I hate to say that, but I heard that, and that's how I knew I was on.
Okay.
But I was just calling, not to defend Chris, because that guy's a little off anyway, but I listen to DJ Shay in the morning. And he wasn't on there at all. So your source, whatever that last guy said, was completely wrong.
You know, I had a little crap detector with that guy.
He wanted the gig.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank
See you later.
Thanks.
All right, thank you. Thank you for the call. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Thank you.
Hey, Don and Mike, how you doing?
Thank you.
We're doing great, thanks.
Hey, there's a movie coming out this Friday called Old School.
Yes, and are you going to ask
it's
about
it? It's Leah Remini in that.
Yeah, our friend TV star Leah Remini has... A small, I understand it, if you get up to go take a leak,
right,
you're going to miss it. I mean, if you blow your nose,
right,
you're going to miss it.
You know, they have it all in the commercial runs, though.
So in the trailers, Leah's in the trailer?
The trailer, yeah. That's how I thought I recognized her, but I said, we haven't heard anything about it, so I just blew it off.
I think we were going to have her on the show sometime.
Is this her feature film debut?
I believe so.
We have to get her on. It looks good.
It's a movie with, I mean, it's so stupid. The parts of it that look good, it's got Daryl Hammond.
Right. Oh, I saw the trailer. Yeah. You know, and I am not a Will Ferrell fan, but the trailer.
Yeah, Will Ferrell, not Daryl Hammond.
Is that Will Ferrell when he's like, doesn't have a shirt on or something?
Yeah.
It looks
It's
fun.
Got one of the Wilson boys in it.
Luke Wilson, I think.
Yeah, it's got the one that we like.
and Vince Vaughn, I think.
Yeah.
There's one funny sequence where he gets shot in the neck with a tranquilizer dart.
That's right.
And that's,
yeah, that's right. That's, it's the most powerful
funny
tranquilizer in the world, and you just go,
okay. We'll get Leon.
He's talking, and they do the thing where he's shortly.
It's Owen Wilson, and maybe we'll
it's Owen Wilson?
Yeah. And maybe we'll have Lisa on the, Leah on the show tomorrow if Lisa will call her. Hello?
Good.
Dynamite.
Yeah, Dynamite, love you guys. You know, I thought when a guy goes through a divorce, he loses a lot of weight. Mike, you let yourself go.
Mike dropped the F-bomb.
Thank you.
Let me just say, I disagree.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
You let yourself go a long time ago.
Thank you. I appreciate
it. So did
that.
I.
Thank you. Absolutely.
We both stopped caring about our appearance about 10 years ago.
Absolutely.
Hey, guess who's back?
Who?
Larry's back.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Oh. Hi.
This is that same lady?
You know what?
You know what? That was very rude of us not to let you have the last word.
We apologize.
And, you know, that was not, you know, it's not what we normally do. We usually
we were having fun with you. We apologize.
And that,
yeah, that is what you usually do because I listen to your show. Yeah.
Well, let us give you the last word.
And you know, really, it is the only control that you have. I understand that. But,
and,
you know,
and
it
please,
was
honey, let me get a word in here. I hope that you read between the lines and you know that we're doing a show and that we're just goofing around. We really, really don't mean any harm. So now, if you can, if you can keep it to 1 minute or less.
Oh, no problem.
We were just doing shtick. I hope you understand that. But really, we need you to keep your question to a minute or less.
Oh, go ahead.
If you hang up on me, I am going to get you.
All right. Well, don't worry about it because we heard that and we would have hung up on you by now.
Yeah.
So, you know, go ahead. But minute or less, ask your little question.
All right. How come you guys?
Oh, that's satisfying.
Too funny. It's too funny, isn't it? How much do you want to bet that dumb bitch calls back?
Sure she will. So call all day.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don and Mike. Sacramento Chicken in here.
Hi there.
Hey, your boy Grant Napier didn't take too kindly to your closing comments last night about him.
Let's all stop and think how little we care about what Grandpa Napier.
That's it. You did it inadvertently.
What he thinks about anything.
Grandpa
Thank you,
Napier.
Though.
Gramps.
Thank you. Goodbye. Hello, Don Mike Show.
Don, Mike, Buzz, I would like to congratulate you on your ratings. People watched your 20 seconds of TV time last night and have watched King of Queens in a month.
That's
you beat out Leah Remedy. Congratulations.
That's wonderful news.
Leah Remedy. We beat out Leah Remedy.
Did they rebroadcast that on the 11th?
Hello, Don and Mike.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Hey. I happened to see a sneak preview of the movie Old School last night, and Leah Remedy's part is less than small.
Yeah, I believe that's what I indicated.
She's married to Vince Vaughn in the movie.
If you sneezed, you were going to miss it.
But the movie actually was pretty funny.
And how was she in it?
She actually looks like she's a little heavier than she looks on TV.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh,
and it just keeps getting better, doesn't it?
Boy.
Well, actually, there were some pretty hot women in the movie.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Oh,
all right,
but
thank
the movie
you.
Was pretty funny.
Thank you, my friend.
Sure.
I'll make sure to keep your name on file.
I like a woman with a little meat on her bone.
Oh,
now, we started this break talking about Senior Bachelorette.
Yeah, that was a while ago. What happened?
I don't know. Well, that lady is what happened.
That's right.
And here's the dealio. We need 10 guys. It's a week from tomorrow, Valentine's Day, when we play Senior Bachelorette. You can see what our lady looks like. She's 62. Go to 1067wjfk.com and look at the pictures of Anna. She's actually the best photo of her is the one taken with Buzz right after they had fabulous sex.
Yes,
you can tell by that glow that she has.
Now,
and me.
We're looking for guys, 10 guys. Well, of course, all 10 guys will win prize packs, but you got to be down here at the station next Friday, and you must be between the ages of 21 and 25.
Very good.
You will have a 5-minute date in our production room with Anna.
Right.
That'll be on the radio.
Yeah, we'll have microphones in there.
Then she will pare it down to 3, and then those 3 will have to do something that we'll tell you about on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And then she'll pick the one, and you go out on a date with her, and then you come back and report, and you win the money. So we have Anna, we got the money, and here is. Dude, what happened? What happened to that thing? What happened to that tape? We had it saved.
Oh. So until further notice.
Well, now we're going to be royally screwed, Charlie.
No, we won't, but the AE would be.
The account executive.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll be fine.
So the sponsor, whose name I won't mention right now, hasn't paid the money yet?
Not yet.
Oh.
But we're still doing the contest.
Yes, we are.
All right, and now we've identified whose account it is.
Rob, would you share, please?
Oh, my. Charlie has identified whose account
it is. Thank you, Charlie. That was very good.
So either way, whether it's the account executive or if it's the client, this is a name I won't mention, we are giving away $2,000 next Friday.
Very good.
And if you want to be one of the bachelors, you must be between 21 and 25. You must be here at WJFK next Friday, and you must be able to go on the date next Friday night, Valentine's Day evening. You must take a tape recorder. We'll supply it, record everything that happened, and report on our next live show.
Very good.
So call now, 877-365-3636. Let's see if we can find 10 guys.
10 guys.
Who want to try to be...
10 hot guys.
The guys.
Yeah.
For the Senior Bachelorette, we come right back. Thanks, I'm cute.
God damn it.
Thing is
a running
no,
pit.
No. Try it again.
No.
This
yes, fine.
Is the Don Good. And Mike Show.
Thanks, Miramax.
I'm sorry, I can't do it. Not over this. And if I know our president, he's not going to allow me or himself to get shot down over what would have been a private sexual encounter.
Some swan song for the old man, huh?
The senator got a little wild when she was 19. What is the big deal?
Let me explain the big deal to you. The people of this nation can stomach quite a bit. The one thing they can't stomach is the image of a vice president with a mouthful of...
You don't have to use... Look, let's use the word alleged.
They got photos. They got witnesses. They got the alleged slut.
Hey, wait a minute. Let me tell you something. I'm a husband first.
The Don and Mike Show.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you. I'm over here now.
What are you, fucking retarded?
Ready to D.O.T. Don and Mike.
Thank you, dude.
I'm over here now.
I know. I got you before.
Click, 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 click.
Let's go to the phone where we have a very surprise. A lot of guys are already calling to be in the Senior Bachelorette contest.
No surprise here. It doesn't surprise me at all. I knew we'd have a throne.
Now, serious contenders only, please.
Please.
No pretenders. Contenders.
Yeah, we want the right type of guys.
Don't be player haters. Be players.
Yeah.
And let's go to, I don't have names.
Are we just going randomly here? Just jot them down, see how we like them?
Yeah, we are. Don and Mike Show. Hi, who's this?
This is Scott.
Hi, Scott. Where are you from?
Falls Church.
How old are you, Scott?
I am 24.
Now, Scott, are you serious about this Senior Bachelorette thing?
I am dead serious.
Have you been to the website to see the picture of Anna?
No, I haven't yet.
So you're doing this based on hearing her lovely voice?
And your descriptions, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And realize, reaction.
You realize you are 24. She is 62.
Yes.
If she was to select you next Friday, Valentine's Day evening, you would go out for a romantic dinner with her.
Romantic dinner ever.
You take a tape recorder. You tape the whole thing.
How do you feel about older women, Scott?
As long as they're over 18, they're fine by me.
Really?
And Scott, let's see, a couple of questions. What do you do for a living?
I'm a consultant.
For what?
IT consulting for the government.
Okay, and who is the celeb you think you most resemble?
The last one that I was told, this is a couple of years ago, was Brady Anderson that used to play for the Orioles.
Brady Anderson, so, always known as a pretty good-looking guy.
Not you, him. That was the big talk. Brady Anderson
click. And how old did you say you were, Scott?
I'm 24.
24. Scott, and we also must ask this, as we'll ask everybody. How come you were available on Valentine's Day?
Because I'm a pretty shy guy, and I don't really date that much.
Really? Okay, that's interesting. Shy, but you're calling the radio.
Correct.
All right, hold on a second.
All right.
I think we might take him as our first guy.
I think he sounds okay.
Hello, Don and Mike Show. Who's this?
Hey, this is Mike.
Hi, Mike. Where are you from?
I'm from Baltimore.
Okay, Mike, first question, most important question. How old are you?
I'm 22.
22.
22, and she is 62.
Yeah.
She is old enough to be your grandma.
Hey, that's all right.
Have you been to the website to see her picture?
No, I have not, but Lisa tells me she's very attractive.
Very, very attractive. And who is the celebrity you most resemble, Mike?
Wow, I don't know. I'm not really sure. I mean, whoever the most handsome man in Hollywood is, I'm sure that's me.
Clooney. So you want
to... All right, I am a great mix of George Clooney and... and somebody else. I don't know.
No, come on, Mike. You got to try a little harder. That's the only thing we really require.
All right. How about Matt Damon and George Clooney?
Matt Damon and George Clooney.
Matt Damon, yes.
And what do you do for a living, sir?
I'm a sales rep.
What do you sell?
I sell cell phones.
Okay. How come you're not available on Valentine's Day?
On Valentine's Day, my girl said it was cool.
I mean, how come you are available?
Oh, his girlfriend.
He's got a girlfriend.
Oh, you have a girlfriend?
Well, no, but, you know.
No, you just said your girl.
You're gone. Oh, like we're sorry.
Too much.
Goodbye.
Too much trouble.
Yeah. Hello, Don, on my show.
Hey, how you guys doing?
See, it's not as easy as just calling up.
No, it isn't. And then, you know, you don't have your celebrity you most resemble, and then you say you got a girlfriend.
You got a regular POA with you. Right. Come on. Hello, Don, on my show.
What's up, guys?
Hey. You know, the most important thing, Don, is we want to protect our Anna.
Who is this?
This is Stan.
Stan, where are you from?
Stan.
Baltimore.
I need no further questions.
Is this Stan the fan?
Oh, no.
Stan, how old are you?
24.
Would you mind if we called you Stanley?
No, you can call me Stosh.
Stosh.
Stosh. Yeah. Even better, I'm putting down Stosh.
Mike, I'm going to say right now, if he says Stosh, he's in.
Absolutely.
A guy who volunteers that information.
That he's Stosh, the other questions are just a formality.
But we must ask, what do you do for a living?
I teach.
Celebrity you think you most resemble?
I guess if you mush together the Coreys.
Corey...
Eamon Feldman.
And I guess that would be the reason you're available on Valentine's Day.
Oh, actually, I have a girlfriend for about 3 years, and we broke up in, like, November-ish.
Perfect, Stosh, you're in.
All right, Stosh.
Great.
We'll see you. Hold on a second.
All right, thanks a lot.
Let's go to another call. Hi, Don and Mike Show. Who's this?
Hey, it's Phil.
Phil, where are you from?
Phil?
Mills. Where are you from, Phil?
Owings Mills.
How old are ye?
21.
Now, this is the perfect age
right.
because it's the closest we're going to get to triple the age. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
You understand? I mean, because triple his age
right.
would be 63.
Right.
And she's 62.
Who is the celebrity you most resemble, Phil?
Mike Silverman from Voodoo Blue. Or maybe like Shaggy from...
Shaggy from Scooby-Doo?
Yeah.
All right, we'll put Shaggy down.
Perfect. What do you do for a living, Phil?
I work at a bookstore.
Okay, that's good. And how come you're alone on Valentine's Day?
I don't know. The only girl who I was really talking to, she's away. She's at school.
And your feelings on older women?
Oh, hey man, whatever. KY will fix it.
Have you been to the website to see the picture of Anna?
I haven't gotten a chance, but I'm going by your description, Lisa's description. So she said the pictures don't do justice.
True. I really think that based on being the first contestant to bring up the concept of lubricant...
KY.
Right.
He's in.
He's in.
All right. Hold on. Hold on, Phil. We'll
Bada
see.
Bing.
See you next Friday. Bada bing. Hello, Don and Mike Show. Who's this?
Hey, Don. Mike, it's David.
Dave. Hi, Dave. Where are you from?
I'm from Woodbridge.
And how old are you, sir?
23.
23. Boy, we're hitting them right in the prime age.
Yeah, absolutely.
We wanted a bunch of young guys to go out with Anna. Mm-hmm. Let me see. What do you do for a living?
I work for a civil engineering consulting firm and go to school at night.
Fair enough. Wow. Celeb you think you most resemble?
I've been told Corey Haim when he was in that Dracula movie.
Another Corey.
Another Corey.
Wow.
And the reason you are going to be alone on Valentine's Day?
Because my girlfriend dumped me for some fat loser.
Mm, there you go.
That's basically it.
Look at that. I mean, we're getting guys that are on the rebound. This is fantastic. And how do you feel about older women?
I love older women. They tend to be less stupid than young women.
There you go.
So you mean that you would, and now is the motivation, and you can be honest, is the motivation for this, it's one of three things. Being involved with the show, the chance to go out and perhaps even find love or at least friendship, or the fact you're going to pocket $500.
Let's say all three.
All three? That's a good answer.
Okay.
That's fair enough right there.
Hold on, you're in. Now, Mike, how many is that?
We have a total. We only eliminated Mike, and that means we have four contestants right now. We've got Scott, Stosh, Phil, and David, and that means we need six more.
All right, let's get one more. We'll get one more today, and then we'll wait till next week and see how many of these guys end up following through.
Yeah, because I think like a guy like Phil, the Shaggy, like, you know, might be Mr. KY might be a little shaky.
Hello,
yeah.
Don and Mike.
Hey, Don, what's up?
Hey, what's your name, my friend?
Neely.
Come again?
Neely, like Neil and then a Y.
Neely.
Neely.
Yeah. Neely. Neely. I nearly hung up on you.
Neely.
Oh.
You have a neely good time.
Yeah,
Do you think that how some people pronounce Nelly's name? Hello. Is this WPGC? Could you play Neely?
Or Neri.
Yeah, it would either be Neely or Neri.
Neri.
Neri. How old are you?
24.
What do you do?
I'm a bartender.
Hey.
Bartender, good line of work. Who's the celebrity you most resemble?
Well, I'm a dark guy, you know. I'm from, my parents are from Bangladesh, so I don't know. Somebody once told me Matt LeBlanc.
How about Abu from The Simpsons?
There you go. That's right. Me.
But, Mike, this would help because we wanted to do the multiracial, multi-nation thing.
And Anna said that she was down with the concept of having a multi-ethnic group.
Mm-hmm. Do you get profiled when you go to the airport?
Hell yeah.
All right, come on, then. Join the club.
Yeah. Well,
how come you're going to be alone on Valentine's Day?
Can't be bothered. I don't know.
Can't be bothered. I like that answer. And if you were to go out with Anna, even though you're 24 and she's 62, would there be any chance at all that if you had a good time with her, that you might want to see her a second time?
Are you kidding? Hell yeah, man. Bridge culture. That's what I'm all about.
Neely is in. Neely is in our Abu lookalike.
That's it. And then that's all for today.
There they are.
That's all for today.
Wonderful.
What we'll do is we'll spend the weekend checking and double checking with these guys to make sure that they're legit and they're on the level. Mike, let's review the five guys that we have. Oh, before you do that.
Yes.
Would somebody run me in Anna's phone number? I'd love to call Anna and have you tell her who we've got.
Very
this
good. I sure hope she was listening too.
Great.
But if she wasn't listening, you could just give her the
guys. I think we got a wonderful wide variety of guys. I was slightly disappointed that we didn't have a gentleman of color. I hope that the next go around that we can yes.
We'll ask for a Negro next time.
Very good.
Anybody out there got Anna's phone number?
Call Anna, get her on the line. Here comes Lisa with the phone number.
Thank you, Lily. Okay, here we go. And this. Call her up.
I also have the number.
Of course. Buzz, save that. The next segment is for you, okay?
Thank you for bringing out your black book, Buzz.
Sorry. Hello, Anna?
Yes.
Hey, it's Don and Mike. Hi there. We're on the radio.
Oh, hi, Don.
Are you listening?
Yes, I was.
Now. Mike's going to recap the five guys that we've selected thus far.
Okay,
Mike, go ahead.
All right, Anna, here they are. Contestant number one is Scott. Scott is 24 years old, and he resembles Brady Anderson, the former ball player for the Baltimore Orioles.
Right.
Our second contestant was Josh. I'm sorry, Stosh. Stosh is a
Stanley.
It's nice to see that you were keeping track also, Anna, at home.
Yes, it was.
And he resembles the Coreys, a combination of both Corey Feldman and Corey Haim.
Haim.
Is it Haim or Haim?
I think
Haim.
It's Haim.
Haim?
Like, I think it's Heimlich and Corey Haim.
Right. And then we have contestant number three, Phil. Phil is 21 years young, and he resembles Shaggy from Scooby-Doo. We have David, our fourth contestant, who is another Corey Haim lookalike. He's 23 years old.
How lucky can one girl get, huh, Anna?
And we round out our first half of guys with Neely. He's his parents were from Bangladesh. He resembles Abu from The Simpsons, and he's 24 years old.
So you heard all the guys. Did they sound like they were pure of heart?
Oh,
weren't they nice?
Mm-hmm.
That
they
was
nice.
So nice.
They were.
Weren't
they nice?
Yes, yeah. At least we got five to call, huh?
How do you feel about Phil's comment about the KY? How did you feel about that?
well, he... I don't know.
Yeah.
Hard to answer that. He's got a good sense of humor, let's say that.
And I will tell you this, that we could have gotten all 10 guys today.
Is that right?
Yeah, we're just going to stretch this into next week.
Stretch it.
Don, I want to tell you that your ratings do not reflect your audience. Because I have never gotten so many calls from so many people. And these are older people. And you always talk about the group, you know, the 44s or the 34 to 44 or whatever.
Right, right.
And you... don't know anything about what's going on in this older group.
There you go. All right. I like that, Anna. That's it. A lot of oldsters listening.
Oh, my goodness. And I got a lot of harassment today. So.
Oh, no, it should be loving harassment. And hold on. We have
Joe.
The Joe alarm has gone off. Yes, Joey.
I have six guys.
Six?
Yeah, a guy named Chris, who is an ugly Brad Pitt. Did you talk to him?
No, we didn't.
No, we didn't.
All right, well, if you guys screened him...
Yeah.
All right.
Do you want to talk to him, or...
Is he on the phone now?
I can call him back.
Would you have, when was this conversation going on?
I picked up and asked if he'd talk to you guys, and he said, yeah.
Well, we were only taking five
Joe,
today.
Joe.
Maybe we can talk to Chris right out of the shoot the next time we do it.
Yeah, we'll call Chris first on Monday or Tuesday.
Did you think we had him on the air?
Yeah.
No, you didn't.
No. Did you, Joe? Did you think we had him on the air?
Yeah, well, I mean, we were busy dealing with all the other guys, so he got mixed up in the loop.
Okay.
Right, okay. All right, thank you, Joey. And now here's Lisa.
We're all in here.
Hey, it's a party.
Right?
Excuse me. I picked up the phone and said, hey, did Don and Mike talk to you yet? He said, yeah. I said, all right, great. Well, we'll see you at 3 o'clock on Friday.
Something to look forward to. We'll have a dumb guy to round out the next time.
Wild card.
No, not necessarily dumb. A guy who... is one of those guys that just, like, walks in and takes charge.
Oh, right,
I mean, why not? If somebody says, were you on the air? Yes, I was.
They picked me. They said I was the best.
Absolutely.
That's initiative.
That's right, Anna. There you
Amen.
Go. Now, Anna, have you seen your photos on the website?
Yes, they're awful, aren't they?
No.
That was very kind of you to say that, and I also want to thank Buzz for coming out and getting in the picture with me. That was very nice of him. Yeah.
Couldn't pass that.
He'd not only get in the picture, Anna, he'd get in a hot tub with you.
What you don't notice in this picture is where Anna's right hand is.
Yeah.
I mean, you can clearly see Buzz's left hand on Anna's shoulder.
We like to call that picture the grip of love.
Thank you, Anna.
He has my heart. He knows that.
Okay.
I've listened to you guys for years, and he's always...
Shame we can't put Buzz in the top 10.
Yeah. Everybody wanted to know right away what Buzz looked like.
Of course.
So now I'm happy that I'm out there with him and they can see.
Well, you tell them as they slip on their Ensure, and they slip on their Depends.
Right.
That Buzz is the man. Hold on.
Uh-huh.
I got listeners want to speak to you, Anna. Here's Betty. Hello, Betty.
Hi, Don.
Hi there. You're on the air with Anna.
Anna.
Hi, Betty.
Don and Mike put my husband John and I together some years ago.
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh, my God. Hold on. Betty. Is this Betty from Reno?
Yes.
Betty, what a voice from the past. How are you?
I'm great. We'll be married 5 years the end of this month.
Wow.
Congratulations,
That's
Betty.
Wonderful, Betty.
And Anna.
Yes.
Even though my husband's not younger than I, you would think he was.
Is that right?
Yeah, sometimes.
5 years of marriage went back when. I remember when you two kids met, we thought you might end up being a hole in the desert.
Right.
Well, we could hope that perhaps
Anna, just be yourself. You know, these guys are in their 20s, from what I understand.
Yeah.
And
God.
Just be yourself, and if they want...
You're listening to Menopause to Menopause.
I mean, gosh, you're only 62. I'm 66 now, and I'm rolling in the hay several times a week.
Welcome to our new show.
Yeah,
I'm dry like you.
Don't try to look like you know... 25. Look your age, act your age, but have a great time.
Yeah,
well,
good advice.
I'm trying to.
All right, baby.
Well, what I'm hoping, Betty, is that one of these guys will have a father or perhaps a grandfather.
Oh,
and they'll
no,
like me
no.
And they'll take me right on over there.
A 24-year-old, if you're compatible,
Keith. Yeah. Yeah, this is like when Andy and Mayberry wanted to pick up the phone and the Pigeon Sisters were on. And Andy would always have to say to the operator, you know, get these ladies on the phone. Betty?
Yes?
We'll talk to you soon. Goodbye.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Anna?
Bye, Betty. Thanks for calling.
Sure, Anna. Have a good time.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, that's all great. Right. Anna, we will talk to you next week.
Bus is leaving.
Have a great weekend, Anna.
Thank you, Don.
We'll talk
Thanks,
to you.
Thanks, Mike.
You're
Everybody's
welcome, Anna.
Wonderful.
Talk to you next week and look forward to seeing you in studio Friday.
Okay, great.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now. Bye. Jesus Christ.
Bye.
Yeah.
There you go.
Wow.
That was like my mother-in-law. That was like a Twilight Zone of dueling mother-in-laws there.
Right. Yeah, they could have gone, really, the rest of the show.
Hello, Don and Mike show.
Hi. Good afternoon, Don and Mike. Thanks for taking
a little
my
burp?
Call.
Was that a little burp there?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Oh, it's funny.
But
my mother...
I only date old women.
Okay.
I only date them because, you know, it's good. Because, one, they got great Social Security checks, and I'm real fat. And I don't bathe, and it's real nice to date some old women's, and I'm black, and I can't get me a white woman.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to give some advice to these boys, these young boys. See, I'm in my 30s now, so I don't, yes. You know, I don't get them women's too much anymore.
How fat are you?
Who is this, Russ Parr?
What?
Is this Russ Parr?
Tyrone.
No, this is Russ Parr from WKYS.
I swear this is not... Russ, whatever.
Okay.
But it's Tyrone.
Tyrone?
And
Tyrone.
I date women.
Yeah,
I don't
right.
believe him for a second.
I date women's. Hello, Don and Mike show.
Hey, Don, I was wondering if you needed a videotape of Frida on John Edwards today.
No, got it already. Rob got it for us on the Baltimore station.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot. Love
Thank
the show.
You. Thank you, my friend.
Yep, bye.
I was going to say, speaking of older women, my mother-in-law fits that category. I love her. She called me this morning all upset. She said, and I know it's bad when she calls me son. And I pick up the phone and I get, son.
Hi, this is Don's mother-in-law, Big Prius.
She goes, son, there's bad news. And I am bracing myself thinking,
sure.
What the F next?
Yeah, said, right.
Robin, that's my sister-in-law, just called. Channel 9 is preempting the show. To cover the memorial to the astronauts.
She was looking forward to our little thing we were going to do.
She wanted her time on the airwaves.
Right.
So good for you, Big Frida. Sure, you looked great, even though I didn't get a chance to watch it on the show. Because, you know, that's the type of guy I am.
Yeah.
Hello, Don and Mike show. Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, blah,
blah. Blah, 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 blah.
No, it's not blah, blah. It's... Va 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 va.
Va 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 va. My bad.
Yeah.
It was like some that Joe guy's such a dick.
That's like a rhetorical question.
I don't. I just, you know, every time I call him or talk, you know, he's like, no thanks, goodbye.
Would you like to? Would you like to speak to him?
Hold on a second. I don't mind this.
I mean, I think Joe needs to answer that.
Hey, Joe. One of your haters is on the line.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, buddy. Why are you such a dick?
What do you want
to tell me? Hold on. You can't drop the S-bomb like you just did.
Oh, I don't think I did, Don.
No, you did. You said S-H-I.
It sounded like she, you know.
Okay, I'm sorry.
All right, so that's the first reason I probably hung up on you.
Joe.
Well, yeah,
let me ask you
one
more time. What do you want to talk to Don and Mike about?
I want to talk about Don and Mike, about how much a dick you are.
All right, well, you're going to have to work harder than that. A lot of people call it that topic.
Yeah, I understand. Maybe you need to find a new job, bro.
What?
Maybe you need to find a new job, bro.
No, I don't, actually. It's the best job I've ever had.
Now, and listen, I got to tell you something. We like Joe. We like Joe, and we like the job he's doing.
Okay, well, that's cool, then. I'm not almost out here like Joe too much, okay?
Hey,
Don and Mike, I love you guys, man. Have a good day.
I was looking for a little more there.
Me too. I said advantage in that round.
Joe.
Joe won.
And
that
Joe
round.
Is able to be controlled. You know, Joe's normally somebody who'll say something outrageous.
All right, goodbye, Joey.
Bye
bye. There he goes.
Joe's having one of his low energy days.
All right, time for a brand new bit. Robbie, where's that fanfare?
Okay.
That green cart, that real
cheesy dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Going to roll out a brand new bit. I've been working overtime. We had affiliate roulette this week.
Right.
And now we're going to roll out a brand new one. Not necessarily a prize involved here, unless you really make it happen.
Oh, contraire, mon frère.
It's called Buzz Makes the Sex Call for You.
Very good. Hey, baby.
And let's say there are intimate details that you want to tell somebody, but for whatever reason, you're too shy.
Like something you want from your partner?
Yes.
Something you need from your partner, or something that you want to give to your partner?
Or let's say you want to just give a compliment for something done. Or you want to say there's something that could be done better that's not being done.
But you want to do it through the mouth of someone with experience.
Maybe you have an offer for someone. Maybe you want to tell someone you've been together, you've had sex, goodbye.
But maybe you just are too shy to handle that sexual content.
I can help you out.
Whatever it is, the call must be of a sexual nature.
Please. Because we've got a guy here that can do that for you.
So what you do is you call us now at 877-365-3636.
It's going to be interesting when the women call in to have a Buzz call a man.
Well, Mike, hopefully that's part of the way it'll work.
That's kind of what I was doing there.
We'll go both ways, though, as always on this show. Guys and girls can call.
So does Buzz.
With Buzz making the sex call for you. We'll select the call that intrigues us the most. And then Buzz,
yes,
using his voice, will call. And for instance, I'll give you a situation.
Okay.
And Buzz, you can tell us what the call would sound like very briefly.
Right.
My wife indicated that she's had a dream about me.
Mm-hmm.
I've lost 36 pounds. She can now get her arms all the way around me. And she said that she had a sex dream about me last night where I was taking her
sex dream
from behind, but not in the bad spot.
Mm-hmm.
You're
going to
be deleted.
Together.
You can say it.
God, I hate that.
Mike, I think you can just say doggy.
Doggy.
That's okay.
Now, God, the rules we have to live by.
Brilliant, doesn't it?
I'm not into doggy. But
he's doggy, here, doggy.
Maybe I would have you call my wife to say she's lovely, she's charming, she's sexy, but I just don't want it doggy.
Or maybe, you know, the wife would be calling.
Oh, yeah, or maybe. Right.
And the call would be made from Buzz to you to kind of cajole you into doing doggy.
All right, let's work on that scenario.
Because
right.
That would be the more plausible one.
Do we have the phone ring sound effect?
Sure.
Okay. So I'm just sitting around. My telephone rings. Hello, Don here.
Hey, Don.
Hi.
Buzz Burbank here.
Hey, Buzz, what are you doing?
I'm calling on behalf of your wife, Frida. Your sexy, lovely wife, Frida.
Yeah, Buzz.
She asked me to give you a call.
Yeah.
She had a dream about you, you know.
I heard about that.
The sex dream.
Yeah.
The sex dream.
Yeah.
She dreamed you took her from behind. And she wants you to consider that, Don.
Hey, Buzz?
Yeah.
What are you, high?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so you got an idea how this works?
I tell you, I like it already.
We'll pick the best call. Buzz will make the call. Maybe we'll throw some prizes your way. 877-365-3636. We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Miss Purdy, are you and Sherman having relations?
That's a good question. No, Grandma. It's not like that. We're colleagues.
Oh.
We just work together.
Oh, yeah, that's how I start out, colleague. Me and your grandfather was colleague. Next thing you know, he's on top of me in the shed, pumping and sweating.
Yeah, Mo, it's not like that.
Grandma, when you hush up, you never brought a girl home. The least you can do is let us talk to her.
Well, I'd like to get to know her a little better myself. Ain't nothing wrong with admiration. Don't be ashamed of that. Relations is beautiful. When I was young, I used to always have relations. Every night, if a nice gentleman bring me flowers and candy, take me to a movie, show me a lovely evening, then I would take him home and give him hot, lovely relations. Relations is a beautiful thing. Ain't nothing to be ashamed of, especially to young people. I think
that's
it's
your way.
You know, sometimes when I'm alone, I relate to myself.
The Don and Mike Show. You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe.
We were late there. That was my fault.
Are you f***ing retarded?
Yeah.
Two corny bastards who can't do interpretations. The Don and Mike Show.
All right, welcome to Buzz Makes the Sex Call for You.
All right.
We have all kinds of situations here on the phone. We have Buzz calling guys on behalf of girls.
Right.
But I think we'll wait for the right situation. Let's check out each of these callers. Is this Dion?
Yeah, what's up, Don Mike?
Dion, hey, where are you from?
I'm from Sacramento.
Sacramento?
Sacramento.
A-H-T-K, you would like Buzz to...
call my wife, Melissa.
Place a sex call to your wife, Melissa. And what is it that you want Buzz to say in the sex call?
I'm hoping he will turn her on so that she will come home and just have sex with me because she needs to give it up.
I like the idea of the generic get Buzz to work up the woman call.
All right, hold on a second, please.
He'd be good. You can handle that one, right, Buzz?
Absolutely.
Hold on, Dion. Let's try Ken. Hi, Ken.
Hi, how you doing?
We're doing great. Where are you from?
From Seattle, Washington.
On KQBZ.
Yes, I got two girls that I work with. I had them over to my house, and we're doing some tequila shooters, and I'd like to do it again and get a three-way going with them.
So do you have one girl that's a regular, let's say your regular girlfriend?
No, they're neither one of them is my girlfriend. One of them is married.
Well, now, you had both of these girls over at your apartment at separate times?
We had them either at the same time.
You had a three-way.
And you were just doing shooters. You didn't have any sex.
Yeah, but we'd like to take it one step farther.
You'd like to take it to another step, and you'd like to have sex with both of these women.
And you want Buzz to call and ask. That's even better than the last one.
That's fantastic.
Hold on a second. Hold on, please. We'll come back to you. Here's Jen. Hi, Jen.
Hi, guys.
Hi, where are you from?
I'm from Woodbridge.
WJFK. Jen, who would you like Sexy Buzz to call?
I would like him to call my husband.
And what can Buzz do for you when he calls your husband?
Well, I went to a sex party, ladies' party, where they talked about creams and toys and that kind of thing, and I got a black cherry-flavored cream, and I would like my husband to, I'm not sure if I can say...
Use initials then. Mm-hmm.
I would like him to lick the cream off my no-no spot.
Oh yeah.
Okay. You mean where food comes out?
Yeah, baby.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yuck. Pig. Hold on,
stop it.
Please.
Stop it.
I don't mean that like physically. I just mean that, like, pigs. Jen, I'm sorry to lecture, but I can't help it. Let me ask you.
Oh, now you're taking the sex out of the sex room.
Have you had a meal yet today?
Yes, I have, but very early in the morning. And I would only ask him to do it after I took a long soak in the tub.
What did you have this morning?
I had toast.
All right, let me explain to you how this works.
Here we go.
You eat the toast through your mouth. Down your esophagus goes down your stomach.
Yes.
Then you have acid in your stomach that breaks the food up. And then it passes through your bowels. And then eventually it becomes
BM.
And it comes out a place that I'm going to call the bad place. And
right.
See, what you have to remember is when you want your husband to put his lips there, that's where food comes out. But again, that's up to you.
I think she probably knew everything you just told
her. I'm sure she did. I just like getting my side in.
You'd like to explain that. And you know, that's one of the best descriptions you've ever given of the food process.
Where food comes out.
Very good.
And here is Chuck. Hey, Chuck.
How you doing, guy?
We're doing great. Where are you from, Chuck?
I'm from Spotsylvania.
WJFK, right.
You better believe it.
Chuck, who would you like Buzz to call?
I would like Buzz to call my newlywed wife.
Ah.
And we've had a great sex life, mind you, but after we've got married, and I know you don't like this subject, but she used to let me play with the no-no spot.
The second no-no spot call.
Didn't you just hear the last lecture?
I know, but there's two sides to this. She does not let me, how shall I say, seed the chest.
What was that?
Seed the chest.
He cannot plant his fertile seed.
Okay.
On chest. And that's something that I feel that I'm really missing.
So you want to basically...
You want to give her a pearl necklace?
Yes, exactly.
And she doesn't like that?
Well, I talked about it, and it's come about, but it's
never actually happened. Hold on. I've seen this in movies. Mm-hmm. You want to give her a pearl necklace on her butt?
No, on her chest.
I'm all for the pearl necklace part, I'm anti... Play where
well,
food
but
comes
I mean,
out.
You know, when true. Buss makes the sex call, Don, these are, you know, it's not you making the call.
I understand.
I can sell what both these of people these. Want.
I understand. So let's review. We have Dion and his wife, Melissa.
Okay.
We have Ken and the friend, Kimberly.
Right.
We have Jen and her husband, Matt.
Mm-hmm.
Chuck and his wife, Paula.
You got all the information on all these calls, Buzz?
Just about,
Buzz,
yes.
Which one did you like, Buzz?
I like the last two. I think I especially like the last one, Chuck, because he has two requests, and I'd like to pursue both of them.
Way to go, Buzz.
All right, let's try to call Paula.
Buzz does not shy away from the no-no calls.
Oh, let me at this, so to speak.
Now, Buzz, I'll tell her she's on the air, but then the deal is you have to make the sex call mm-hmm. with your sex voice.
Understand. I'm ready.
He's ready.
There's her in.
He is ready.
Hold on. Let me get her now. Her name is
Paula.
Paula.
Mm-hmm. I'm laughing in anticipation of it.
Hello, is this Paula? Hi, Paula. This is Don from the Don and Mike Show. And we have your husband Chuck on the other line. Can we put you on the radio for a second? Okay, she says sure. All right, she's a good sport.
This is who?
This is Paula.
Hi, Paula.
Hi.
Hi, Paula. Now, before we start, let me prove to you that your husband, Chuck, is on the line. Chuck, you want to say hi to Paula?
How you doing?
Hi, sweetie.
Okay.
Hello.
Hold on.
I hurt you now?
No need to hurt him yet.
Hold on there, Chuck. Now, Paula, our friend Buzz, who is our news guy, wants to have a chat with you.
Yeah, it's been requested that Buzz have a word with you, Paula.
Your husband asked. So now, without further ado, Buzz, here is Paula.
Hey. Hey, Paula. Hey, baby. I'm calling on behalf of your lover, your stud man, Chuck. Chuck had a couple of requests he wanted me to pass along to you. You ready to hear those, baby?
Sure.
Yeah, see?
You might like these. In fact, I know you will. Chuck has two requests, Paula. First, and baby, consider this, please.
Wait.
First, he wants his new bride to let him play with the no-no spot. Let him touch that special place. He says you'll be glad if you let him. Would you consider that, Paula? Would you do it for me?
Oh, my God.
Would you, Paula?
I will talk to him about that.
You'll consider it, baby?
I'll talk to him about that.
He and I will both appreciate it. And Chuck had another request, Paula. You ready for his other request, Paula? Chuck would like to give you something very special.
Baby, take it all.
He'd like to give you a gift.
Take it all.
He'd like to give you a gift of love jewelry. He'd like to give you a pearl necklace of your very own. Would you accept that gift from him, Paula? Would you take that gift of love for him?
Take it all.
For me?
All.
Paula?
Paula?
Yes?
What's your answer, baby?
Another thing I'll have to discuss with my husband.
Oh, Paula, why do you have to?
What
is there to think about, baby?
A failure.
A total failure.
What is there to think about?
Buzz's part.
No, Buzz, I don't think Buzz could have done a better job.
Chuck, get ready for a lifetime of misery.
Sorry, you know, I think Buzz, you got to thank Buzz, Chuck, because he did the best.
Hello?
He did the best
Hello?
Job he could.
Yeah. Yes.
Chuck, get ready for a lifetime of misery. Buzz laid his best sex rap on your wife.
And she didn't come along, unfortunately.
I know you tried, and Buzz, thank you very much.
I tried, Chuck. You should ask these questions up front, man.
Yeah, I know.
All right. Goodbye.
Good luck to both of
you.
Goodbye.
Wow. Bye.
Wow. No payoff there.
Boy, Buzz, yeah, I don't think he could have done any, but I thought she was going to crumble.
But I don't want to just stick with the ass. Yeah. If you'll pardon the pun.
I understand. We're right. Something different.
Why not?
We have, Buzz, again, I'll leave it to you. Mm-hmm. We have Ken,
right,
who wants to ask Kimberly, who he's only done shooters with,
right,
to have three-way sex.
That's kind of my favorite.
That's strong. Yeah, yeah, I like that.
That's pretty good. You want to go
that
there?
Yeah, let's do that one.
Okay.
That's like really trying to initiate a rendezvous. That's
hello,
terrific.
Ken?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hello.
Hi, Ken.
All right. Here's the deal. There's two of them. There's two of them I work with.
And they're both named Kimberly?
No, one's Kimberly, one's Rebecca.
Now, is Kimberly the easier mark of the two?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. But who we're calling?
And calling her. They work together.
Okay.
And they were both over the house. They were both doing tequila shooters. And
you have this fantasy. You've explained it.
All
yeah.
right.
And,
yeah, I think
on.
I grew up in
hold on. We can handle it. Hold on a second. Here
the gist of it, so to speak.
The gist of it. Hold on.
He wants to do more shooters, wants to have a threesome,
mm-hmm,
and wants to go to the no-no.
All right, what I got to do is get her.
No, that wasn't in there.
No, that wasn't in there. I'm sorry.
If all goes well.
And again, that's Kimberly or Rebecca, please. Okay, it's very important. This is a high-priority call.
It is.
Very good.
Both of those ladies have someone at their desk.
And
I'm getting a ring now.
Amazed that we didn't have success on that.
Hi, Kimberly. Hello, my name is Don, and I do a radio show with Mike called The Don and Mike Show. And we have a guy who works with you named Ken, who's on the phone with us. I'm not kidding. You want to come on the radio and talk to him? Okay, she says, sure. So here we go. Here is
Kimberly.
Kimberly, and here is Ken. Hi, Ken.
Hi, Kimberly. How you doing?
I'm doing good, Ken. How are you?
Fine.
Okay.
We're having fun on there.
Hold on there, Ken.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just so you see that's really Ken.
Mm-hmm.
Ken asked us to help him out. He's got a dilemma, and we've got somebody on the show that normally takes care of these type of things.
I want you to say hi to our friend Buzz.
Oh, hi, Buzz.
Hi, Kimberly.
And Buzz is going to speak to you now. Go ahead, Buzz.
Hey, baby.
Happening.
Hi, Kimberly. How are you?
I'm pretty good.
I hear you're hot.
Well, it's a fact.
That's what Ken tells me. I think Rebecca would agree.
Oh, I think she would.
Yeah. Remember the fun you guys had the other night doing shooting? Do you remember that, Kimberly?
I do. It's most of it, anyway.
Would you like to relive that moment?
Oh, God.
Would you like to take that moment to the next level?
Meaning what?
You know, a little get together with Ken and Kimberly and Rebecca.
You know, that seems to happen nearly every day.
Really?
Well, not in the way you're thinking.
Well, I'd like you to think the way I'm thinking.
All right.
I gotta close the deal here, Buzzy.
Think about a three-way with Ken and Rebecca. After some more shooters, feeling all warm inside.
All right.
Sounds good, doesn't it?
Not too bad.
Hey. A menage a trois?
That's French.
Little group action?
Hey, Buzz, can you hang on a sec?
Oh, baby.
Oh, no.
Oh, I know.
You're killing
me. Sure you can hold on.
All right,
Buzz.
One second.
I can hold on to something.
Buzz, I think she's coming along.
She seems to be agreeable.
She seems to be, you know.
Yeah.
So this thing, you know, you gotta
she's
really,
open.
Really
gotta
nail it. Really close it. ABC.
All right, what's going on?
Kimberly, I'm calling on behalf of Ken. Ken wanted me to call you and talk about this idea that I know you're going to like.
Oh, really?
How are we going to make this happen, Kimberly? How are we going to make this happen?
No. I have no idea.
Kimberly,
mm-hmm,
love between two people is a beautiful thing.
I love that three, Buzz.
Love between three people is incredible. What do you think, Kimberly?
I'm not opposed to it.
Ken and Rebecca are going to be so glad to hear that, baby.
There you go.
Now, Buzz, now you get to bring Ken into this.
Fantastic. Good job, Buzz.
Thank you.
They can. It can.
Awesome, Buzz.
Thank you. Good luck, Ken. Congratulations.
Yeah, I don't know if you heard that, but it sounded to me like she said yes to three-way.
Yeah, and now it's I think it's up to Kimberly and Ken to bring Rebecca into the fold.
Yeah, Kimberly, how do you feel about Rebecca?
Hi.
Or Buzz, why don't you ask?
Kimberly. Do you find Rebecca as attractive as she finds you?
Oh, yeah, she's hot.
Bingo.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
That's a winner. That's a winner.
Was that the right answer?
That's the best answer,
oh,
baby.
You've made, you've made Ken very happy, Ken.
You've made me very happy,
Ken. You've made Buzz happy, too.
Well, that's why I'm here.
Ken, I have to know, who is the celebrity that this girl most resembles?
That who resembles?
Kimberly.
Come on, Ken.
Jeez.
Yeah, mumbling, bumbling, stumbling, dullard.
You're going to get two girls.
I'll go with Demi Moore.
Demi Moore. Oh, wow.
Baby. And Kimberly, this dullard that you've decided to shag up with, Ken, can you tell me the celebrity you think he most resembles?
Tom DeLuise.
Was that him that said that?
Yeah.
Hey, all the better.
All right, let's go with that.
And what about Rebecca? Who's the celebrity she most resembles? Either Ken or Kimberly can answer that question.
Oh, Ken, go ahead. You've got a better eye.
Go ahead, Ken. Come on, Ken.
Linda, who's the one who played Wonder Woman?
Linda Carter.
Carter.
Two hot brunettes. Wow. Fantastic.
Well, listen, this has been a great...
Two hot brunettes climbing on Dom DeLuise.
This has been a great first edition of Buzz Makes the Sex Call for You.
And enjoyed it.
Buzz, why don't you give both Ken and Kimberly your blessing here as we sign off.
Ken and Kimberly.
Take it off.
Mm-hmm.
I want to give you my love. I want each of you to give each other your love.
Take it off.
And I want each of you to give Rebecca your love. Do it for me.
Buzz.
Yeah.
Buzz. We're looking at each other right now. Buzz, we're looking at each other.
Oh, they're in the office.
That's right.
They're
working in the same office together.
What are his eyes saying to you, Kimberly?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Wow. Go for it.
Take it off.
Bye, guys.
Go for it. Fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have fun, kid.
See you.
All right. Bye.
No prizes necessary, Don.
That's it.
He got his prize.
Hey, way to go, stud.
Nicely done, Buzz.
Wow. You did it, Buzz.
That would be the debut of a feature I know you're going to hear again.
Wow.
That was fun.
Buzz makes the sex call for
Buzz,
you.
Buzz, awesome job.
Thank you. Enjoyed it. Enjoyed it, man.
You know, this is his wheelhouse.
Yeah. Like what he does on the weekend, anyway.
I'd like to think we did some good here today.
Fantastic.
All right, go back to talking like yourself.
I can't. No.
I can't. Thank you, Buzz.
You bet.
Thank you, Kimberly.
Buzz, see me during the break. I need you to make a call for me.
Got it. And Jen and everybody else. That's a good one, Buzz.
Yeah, that was fun.
Good. So you're back to being yourself?
Yeah,
don't talk like that, like if we're in the John.
Yeah, no. Okay, no, that'll never happen. Trust me, that'll never happen.
In the John where the food comes
out. Because a lot of times, you know, like Buzz and I are talking, we're going to the bathroom, and Buzz would be talking to me, and I would hate to be standing there.
Not
going to
happen.
Let's just imagine. I'm standing there peeing.
Why are we imagining?
Just for fun.
You're scaring me.
I'm just for goof.
Hey, Don. That's quite a shirt.
No offense, Mike.
I know, I don't do it like he does. I know.
Buzz?
Hey, Donnie.
Okay.
All right, can I go throw up now?
Fancy
right.
Meeting you here.
Oh!
All right.
Oh, God.
Okay. We'll be right back, everybody.
It's the Don and Mike Show.
Thank you, Dr. Gordon.
Good.
Mike, it's great.
Mm-hmm.
Live spots are back.
I am happy.
And now we're doing them for Vermont Teddy Bear.
Mm.
And we had a meeting with a lady from Vermont Teddy Bear. And I don't think it's in the copy. But Vermont Teddy Bear this year is all about sex.
These are hot little bears this year. And I don't remember a year where you had hotter, sexier bears than this year, Don. These are firecrackers, these bears.
I mean, they've done the cutesy-wootsy stuff in the past, but let's face it, this year they have a jungle love bear.
Mm-hmm.
Draw your own conclusion.
All you have to do is call 1-800-829-BEAR, and one of their counselors helps you choose from over 100 bears, handcrafted in Vermont and delivered in a colorful gift box with a free card and chocolate.
Overnight Valentine's Day delivery guaranteed. Call 1-800-829-BEAR. Shop online, VermontTeddyBear.com. Tell them Donaldo E. Miguel sent you.
M-I-W-J-F-K.
W-J-F-K.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Have you seen the new intern? Extraordinary. Wouldn't I like to give her the old pork sausage? Hello, Jimmy Dean.
The Don and Mike Show.
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
What up, my yellow brothers? Kinks in the house!
No, that doesn't make no sense.
God smiles on them, then God laughs at them. Don Geronimo and Michael Mara.
We got no chinks in the house. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
It's going to snow here, so I'm not going to the hardware store to work tomorrow.
Are you calling from where?
Philadelphia.
I think that's good judgment. I wouldn't go to the hardware store either.
Congratulations on losing all that weight.
Is this Joe's guy?
Yes.
Joe.
Joe's fan?
Yeah, this is the guy who wants Joe to get a raise.
Mm-hmm.
Can you guys start giving Joe more airtime?
No. Hello, Don and Mike Show. Hola. All right. Hi, Don and Mike.
I talked to Don and Mike about a 60-year-old iPad when I was 21.
Well, you know what? They'd love to hear that if only you realized that you were on the air.
I will be very tactful.
You still don't realize you're talking to them.
Oh.
Did you like it?
We were banging like a screen.
He doesn't get it.
No.
Hi, Don and Mike.
We gave him a chance when we could have done something, and he blew it.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
We're doing great, thank you.
Okay. I'm having the best time riding home tonight. I'm moist and everything.
Oh. Because of Buzz?
Oh, my God, yes.
Okay. That's enough of that.
Look what
moist.
I've done.
Enough
what you've
of
done.
That.
Brash tray all full.
Jesus Christ. Hello,
moist.
Never mind, moist.
I am moist.
Don and Mike, hello.
Homo Joe here, Don and Mike. How you guys doing?
Hey, homosexual Joseph, what's happening?
Oh, nothing much. I just figured to let you guys know I'm in the process of a move on Valentine's Day for myself. That's my present.
Where are you moving, Joe?
To Severna Park, Maryland.
Really, are you?
Really, do they allow fags out there?
I don't know, but I'll be the first one to find out, won't I?
Boy, and how's everything going in your world, Joe?
Well, I wore all the men out in D.C. I thought it was a time for a change, so you know how that goes.
Joe, the name of the young Venezuelan Argentinian boy that man boy you're having your way with now?
Well, it was actually a Scandinavian blonde hair, blue-eyed guy.
Wow. Are you still with him?
Yeah, I've been seeing him off and on for 4 years.
What's his first name?
Tom.
Tom.
Mm-hmm.
Tomcat.
Sure it is.
Mm-hmm.
Tom.
He's a Tomcat.
Oh, Tomcat, yes.
Tomcat. Well, HJ, glad you checked in.
I want to just check with you guys, and maybe someday I'll take you out. I'll have a house on the water so we can do the boat thing, maybe.
Joe, I don't want to get you too. I don't want to get you too excited, but you know, Severna Park is very close to the United States Naval Academy.
I know that. All midshipmen.
Coincidence?
All those seamen.
All the seamen. I might have to check it out. You know, take the boat down and ride down.
Bye, Joe.
Bye, bye.
Bye, bye. Hello.
Imagine him on commencement there.
Don and Mike.
Hey.
Hey.
How come your station in Vegas, like, has a customer hotline and, like, you call voicemail and stuff? Anyway, they play commercials, like, every hour during the show with, like, about 5 minutes straight of people saying how you suck.
Yeah, that's called backwards advertising. A lot of stations do that. You know, what you really have to worry about is when you don't hear anything about us on your radio station.
Okay.
There's two ways of doing it. There's the way they do it here on WJFK, and the way they do it on YSP, the way they do it on, I think maybe even on KHTK. They just pound the show.
Right.
They do Don and Mike show, and they play, clips of the show. Or they do it that way, where they say, you know, in Las Vegas, is it KSFN?
KSFN, yeah.
Right, they say, you know, this is KSFN, the Don and Mike show. What do you think about this show? And, of course, they're putting those calls on the air.
Right, to generate interest. That's what they're doing.
Controversy. So trust me, it's a good thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't worry about it. Thank you, my friend.
Thanks for calling us.
From Lisa.com, Lisa loves the Internet.
Yes, she does.
And she brings me all these websites, and some of them are, frankly, not airworthy, but a lot of them are.
Right.
For instance, have you ever been to StoolFairy.com?
Every day.
Have you ever been wondering what to do with all your extra leftover feces? Sure, you can flush if you want, or you can leave your stool behind. But now turn your stool into fabulous prizes with the help of the Stool Fairy. Anyway, it's a gag, but you can order T-shirts and...
Stool Fairy. That's pretty nice.
Here's another one, which is Worse.com. And this is almost like...
Worse.com?
Which is Worse.com.
Which is Worse.com.
And it's almost like a Who Would You Do?
Okay.
Very interesting. We can each answer, which is worse?
All right.
Your mom showing off her cleavage or your dad showing off his butt crack?
Boy, that's tough. I would say...
I'd say my mom.
My mom also, yeah. That's a very tough question.
Which is worse, getting the answer wrong because it seemed too obvious, or getting the answer wrong because you are just stupid?
Getting the answer wrong because you're just stupid.
Agreed. Which is worse, having to bite down on a nail file as hard as you can and have someone rip it from your teeth, or putting a toothpick under your toenail and then kicking a ball with your toe as hard as you can? I would say the toenail thing in a heartbeat.
The toothpick, no question.
Which is worse, hacking in to your girlfriend, boyfriend, significant other's email account, or secretly videotaping them in the shower? I think hacking into the mail is worse.
I think videotaping them in the shower would be worse.
Which is worse, standing in line at the DMV, standing in line at the post office, standing in line at a port-a-john at a concert?
Standing in line at a port-a-john at a concert.
DMV.
Because that's fresh for you.
Yeah. Which is worse, having your eyes scooped out with a spoon or having your fingers cut off one by one? I'd say the eye thing.
Yeah, the eyes, the eye, that's got to be horrible.
Here's another one. Which is worse, someone constantly popping gum or somebody constantly whistling?
Whistling. I hate whistling.
I'd go with the gum. Which is worse, only being able to yell for the rest of your life?
You know, I don't mean to interrupt you there, but, you know, when somebody's whistling, I hate it so much. I've never said this on the air before. I hate it so much, and I don't whistle well, but if somebody's whistling, I'll mock whistle. Like if somebody's walking through, you know, going like that into a room, but it's the kind of guy that... And I'll just go...
Mike, yes. Which is worse? Only being able to yell for the rest of your life, or only being able to whisper? I'd say the whisper.
Yell. You'd be able to exist in, with a whisper. With a yell, you wouldn't be able to have a conversation.
All right, we disagree there. Which is worse? Going to school naked,
mm-hmm,
or going to church naked?
Going to school naked.
I say church. You know, again, it's just, you know, yeah, everybody's got...
Subjective, right?
Now, here's one you're going to love, your phobic flyer.
All right.
Which is worse, staying in a plane that's about to crash or jumping out of the plane? I think staying in the plane that's about to crash is worse than jumping out.
I agree. Staying in the plane is worse. I'd rather jump out.
Mike, which is worse, spinning on someone when you talk, or being spit on by someone when they talk?
Of course, being spit on by someone. I hate that experience.
Yeah, agreed. Which is worse, having to kill your dog by putting it to sleep, or finding out the person you married used to be a different sex? These are two that have nothing to do with each other.
They're not related, and I don't think...
I think killing your dog... At least for me.
Oh, no, I would think...
It would be worse than finding out Frida's a man, or used to be a man.
No, I would think finding out that your spouse used to be a man would be pretty horrible.
Well, I love Mr. Palka.
Right. I love my dogs.
Would you put your spouse to sleep, though, when you found that out?
Absolutely.
Yes. Only if she didn't like
it. One more. Which is worse, a car with no heat or a car with no air conditioning?
And that's easy, a car with no air conditioning for me.
A car with no heat.
Mm-hmm. See, and we're different.
It is a life and death matter with a car with no heat. In with air conditioning, you can roll down the windows. I'm just thinking in terms of... I'm taking it to the extreme.
Put on a coat.
Pardon me?
Put on a coat.
Rob, hypothermia is nothing to make fun of.
neither is heat stroke.
Heat stroke, but you can move the car and always get the breeze.
And I was talking with one of the guys in the DOT club not too long ago. One of my friends from high school and junior high.
I didn't know they were still speaking to you.
Two of them are.
All right.
And we were mentioning, because it's so goddamn cold, something that, this guy that I play high school football for, Coach Sidorek, Andy Sidorek.
I remember that.
Who's still at Magruder High School in Montgomery County, Maryland. One day we were doing up-downs. These awful things where you run in place, and then when the a-hole coach says down, you throw yourself on the ground, face forward. Then when he says up, you have to jump back up.
Mm.
And it was... like 85 degrees, and I was dying. And he came over to me, he said, what's your problem? You know, I said, something like, I want some water or something. He said, you're a pussy. He said, you just wait until it's wintertime. And I was giving him lip. I said, when it's winter, I will love it. Because the problem is, when you're hot and you're making us do all this crap out here, man, we're sweating, we can't have water, we're dying. In the winter...
I could see you.
In the winter, though... you can put on layers of clothes, man, and it really doesn't bother you.
You're sitting in there, just you looking up at Coach Sidorek.
And I did.
This crap.
I did. And then I also remember my friend reminded me one day when it was very cold, when Coach Sidorek got the whole team together.
Right.
And he said, right at the end of practice, he says, how many of you remember when Sorcy, what he used to call me,
right?
How many of you remember when Sorcy was so hot this summer? And, of course, the whole team starts going, well, it's nice and cold now, the way that Sorcy said he wanted it. Hey, Sorcy, give us some up-downs.
Wow.
And blew the whistle, and I had to do up-downs.
Wow. Long memory on Coach Sidorek.
The whole time it was like, so, you like the cold weather better than the warm weather, huh? Is that the case? Yes, sir. Yes, sir, doing the up-downs.
Was that before or after he kicked you in the ass?
That was after. That's when I farted. I was the center.
Oh, yeah.
And Jeff Hale was the quarterback. And he came up and he put his hands, and he went, 247! And I farted, and he, seriously... it was during practice. Seriously, put his hands up in the air like ran away. Meanwhile, the whole offensive line is still sitting there. And the coach comes and said, what happened? And Jeff Hale says, he farted.
And you did it on purpose.
And I'm still in my stance. And he comes up to me, and I'm looking around behind me. He goes, did you do that? I said, yeah. And I swear to God, now in this day and age, it would be lawsuit city.
Right.
He seriously... kicked me in the ass with his cleats. Kicked me in the ass and said, you run till I tell you to stop running.
Wow, yeah.
I just spent the rest of the day running. They're practicing. I'm just running around.
Running laps.
Just running around.
We're farting on the quarterback.
Anyway, I got a lot more internet stuff, but we don't have time. WitchesWars.com is a good site.
Very good.
StoolFairy.com is a good site. I don't know how many of you saw. I'm going to set up our next segment. I don't know how many of you saw last night Bob Barker with the prime time Price is Right.
I saw it.
Worth $1 million. Rob saw it.
It was great.
Did anybody win $1 million?
No, because you had to get a dollar and then spend a dollar again.
Got you. Well, I happen to know that Bob was very excited about it.
Sure.
And wants to get some feedback.
Oh, good.
On how the show was last night.
Bob is always very excited to come on our show.
And did you know this?
Yeah.
Bob's in defeat.
Yeah.
Bob is major into feet.
Absolutely. He loves talking about The Price is Right and feet is too loved.
See if you can guess what we're doing next. We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
No.
Yo.
My dear, you know absolutely nothing about prices. Thank you for being on The Price is Right. We are going to have our first showcase showdown after we show you this.
The Don and Mike Show.
Now, which one of my beauties will bump? Which Janice will wind it up and let it go?
It's not the heat, It's the stupidity. The Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, yeah. So last night, CBS brings Bob Barker out of retirement. I mean, out of primetime retirement.
Oh.
Hey, Bob.
Hello. Wonderful. How are you, Donald?
I'm doing fine, Bob.
It's great to be back in your studio on the radio.
Listen, the first thing I got to do is call the line.
Wow.
Because you know it's going to take us a long time to get to the actual...
I am so worried about the snow. You go crazy here in our nation's capital. How are you, Donald?
I'm doing great.
Bob is here.
And Bob?
Yes, I'm Bob.
Oh,
you've got a wrong number. Dial away home. Did you enjoy the Price is Right $1 million spectacular, Donald?
Was not able to catch it, Bob.
No.
Yeah.
You didn't see it? It was on prime time.
I see my long, firm, shapely legs.
Listen
you
up.
You know they feel so smooth and
nice,
silky.
Nice, smooth, shapely legs
all
on the Price is Right.
The Bob,
the beltway will get slippery.
I believe what you're going to be doing is some CBS audience research.
Wonderful. I'd like to find out how many of these lovelies have watched the primetime spectacular.
And I hear you're also into foot sex, which is why
I
we called...
I enjoy the feet. I do. I love delicate little feet with painted toenails, and especially what the kids wear those little rings.
Those
O-rings rings are wonderful.
These hot feet.
I love them.
You get a lot more for only $2.49 to $3.99.
Bob Barker for the Price is Right, reminding you to spay and neuter your pets. Absolutely. Do these girls have pretty feet?
We'll find out, Bob.
Wonderful. I'm Bob Barker.
Okay, we got to pay attention to this part.
All right, pay attention.
Got to get back to the main menu.
Let's rub the heel and play cliffhangers. Play free throw with the toes.
To be connected to women with sexy little feet and toes.
Yes.
Who are ready to get kinky with you.
Hold on one
press
game.
One. Oof.
Okay. Press one.
Remember, to get back to the main menu, you can press star. Anytime.
Wait, Bob, I just have to tell the girls they're on the air. But then
wonderful.
You can tell them who you are.
And then it's all
live. Yeah. Toe-sucking. Uncensored
sucking.
One-on-one call with one of my sexy girlfriends for just $3.50 per minute.
Toe-sucking, and then we'll play hole in
one. To join the 24-hour orgy party line, please press 2.
Will I have to play check
only
game?
Only 3.25 per minute.
Hold on.
Ooh, to listen to private, uncensored adult tales, please press 3.
I want a live girl, and I want
press
her
4
now.
For Dateline connections, or you can
that's
hook up with
I
other
want.
Hot singles.
No.
Only $3
that's
per minute.
That's all those people are on the phone.
Exclusive sexual directory. A list of the most exciting sex lines.
Sexual directory!
Only $2.50 per minute.
I just hit one.
Remember, to get back to the main menu, you can press star at any time.
I'd like to rub my long, skinny microphone on your foot.
All these people, they're on the air. If it's a party line.
Hello?
Don and Mike, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Who's this? Who am I talking to?
This is Holly.
My name is Bob Barker from The Price is Right, Holly. How are you today? Do you have pretty feet?
I have gorgeous feet.
I love feet. Come on down and let's play.
Ooh.
May I ask you a question, Holly?
Sure.
May I ask you a question right now? Do you like The Price is Right?
I love The Price is Right.
Do you know it's the highest rated game show in daytime television? And did you get... Hallie!
What?
Hallie, did you get a chance to see The Price is Right? $1 million spectacular on CBS.
I didn't.
Oh, no. That is not right. Well, then we'll move right along to our game playing. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Why don't you tell Bob Barker what you look like, Holly?
Well?
Do you have big, beautiful breasts?
Yes.
Wonderful. Bob is a breast man, but more than that, Bob is a foot man.
Ooh.
Tell me all, Holly?
What, baby?
Holly, are you listening to me?
I am.
I would like you to describe your feet, Holly.
Well?
Could you describe them to me right now, please?
Yeah, they're size 8.
Oh.
Aren't you missing a toe, Bob?
I
am missing a toe. Holly, would you like to hear about my feet?
Yes.
I'm missing a toe on my right foot. I only have 9 toes on Bob's right foot.
Wow.
I have 10 toes on my left foot. I'm deformed, Hallie. But get right back to describing your feet for me, Hallie. I'd like to hear all about... Are your toenails painted?
They are.
Oh, Hallie, we're going to have great fun. It's going to be my game show on the telephone with Hallie talking about her feet.
Yeah.
And Bob will complete in no time.
Ooh.
Ooh, now describe your feet for Bob right now. How about you give me a detail about your feet, and I will give you a detail about my feet, Hallie.
Oh, okay.
Wonderful. Let's hear about yours first. Go ahead, Hallie. And now time's running. We're going to run the clock, Rod Roddy.
They're size 8. They're really smooth and soft.
Mine are rough and haggard, and I've got webbed toes, Hallie.
Ooh. Well,
webbed toes. That's right, webbing in between Bob's toes. Another detail, Hallie, please. Bob's
My toenails are painted red, and my toes are perfect.
Wonderful. Did you say you have painted toes, and they're painted red?
Yes, I did.
Are they ruby red, Hallie?
They are ruby red.
Wonderful.
Do you think she really knows who she's talking to?
I think she does. Do you know who I am?
Yeah, Bob Barker.
Bob Barker from what game show, Hallie?
The Price is Right.
The Price is Right. Come on down, Hallie.
What?
May I ask you a question, Hallie?
Yes.
What is your favorite game on The Price is Right, Hallie?
The one where the little guy goes up the Alps.
Cliffhanger!
Yes!
Wonderful! I love that one, too. Do you like Bob Barker's Hole in One game?
Yes.
Would you like to play it right now?
This whore really thinks she's talking about
Bad Bob Barker. I love playing games with Hallie, but Hallie, I'm an elderly man, and I don't have any feeling in my left foot.
That's okay.
Hallie, can I ask you a very important question right now on Bob's telephone version of The Price is Right?
Yes.
Are you cross-eyed, Hallie?
No.
Do you have cross eyes?
No.
Do eyes go in both directions, Hallie?
No, they don't go in both directions.
Wonderful. Hallie, do you have big breasts?
Yes.
I like big breasts and little feet.
Ooh.
Hallie, do you have big breasts and little feet?
I do.
Wonderful. We could have so much fun. Do you like men with snow-white hair, Hallie?
Oh, yes.
That's wonderful. Can you lactate?
What's that?
Don't worry about it. It's a big word, Hallie. All right. Without going over, I want you to guess right now. What is the current age of Price's Right game show host Bob Barker's age?
67.
No, wrong. I'm 80.
Can you ask her if Sajak ever called?
Has any other big-time television personality ever called you, Hallie? Has
no.
Pat Sajak ever called you?
No.
Chuck Woolery?
Trebek?
No.
Alex Trebek?
Nope.
Meek Martindale?
Regis? No.
Peter Tamarkin?
Uh-uh.
Bill Cullen?
No.
Anybody?
Regis?
No. The late Ray Combs?
No, just you.
Just me, and what is your favorite game show, Hallie?
The Price is Right.
Now, here's another question for you, Hallie, with your big breasts and your beautiful, wonderful, tiny little feet. Hallie, tell me, who is my announcer on The Price is Right? What is his name?
I don't remember.
Try, Hallie. Come on now. Take your big breasts and your little feet and try.
Oh, I don't remember.
His name is Rod Roddy, and he goes to Thailand for sex shows.
Really?
Do you like sex shows, Hallie?
Mm-hmm.
Then make Bob one right now. Put a sex show on for Bob. Hallie, go.
Oh, how about if I take off all my clothes?
Wonderful. I'll stand by. That's you take your time. What are you taking off first? Tell me, Hallie.
Well, first I'm taking off my shorts.
What kind of shorts are you wearing, Hallie?
Cut off jeans shorts.
Cut off jeans like Daisy Duke.
How much do you think they're worth?
Duke.
How much do you think those are worth? I'm going to guess that the actual retail price without going over of Hallie's little shorts that she's taking off right now is $19.29. Am I right, Hallie?
No.
No. Oh, no. My dear, you know nothing about shorts. Now what are you removing and what's hitting the floor?
My panties.
Panties? And what kind of panties are they? Thongs?
They're white cotton thongs.
Wonderful cotton thongs. That's wonderful. Does Hallie have a wedgie? Bob wants to know. Bob wants to know if Hallie has a wedgie. Who are you listening to?
Bob Barker.
Bob Barker. And what's my game show on television?
Oh, no.
Press 1 for a live.
Oh, no. What happened to Halle?
I don't know.
John Geronimo.
I didn't do anything, Bob.
John Geronimo, you made that happen.
I did not. You saw my hand.
I'm tell you, I am going to tell you right now, Halle was...
Only 3
Halle was just about to take her panties off, and then you went to another call.
What's the man?
You're teasing me.
I promise it was.
You are a CT, Don Geronimo. Don Geronimo is a CT. A big CT.
Why do you know the next girl you're wearing your Depends?
I am wearing Depends, and I will tell you right now, I have had the best time. I have had a wonderful time wearing Depends. I have a special model of Depend undergarments that I wear under... Hello?
I'm listening to you.
Well, Don, what is your name?
Don and Mike Show, you're on the
Savannah.
Air.
Savannah.
I'm sorry, your name is what?
Savannah.
And you're on the air, Savannah.
Savannah like Georgia?
Yeah, but I'm here in California.
Oh, I am too. I am calling you from CBS Television City.
Oh, wow.
Can you guess? I will tell you something, Savannah.
What?
I'm going to tell you something, and then you're going to guess what I do. Are you ready?
Okay.
Here we go, Savannah. Here's your chance.
Okay.
I am in television. Can you tell me, Savannah, what type of television show do I do?
Probably some kind of talk show.
No, that's wrong. It's a game show. Now, for a big prize for you, Savannah, I will give you my Depend undergarments right off my body if you can tell me what is the game show that I am the host of, Savannah.
Oh, my God. That's going to be a hard one.
Come on now. I'm very old.
Oh, it can't be a...
I'm old. Now, remember, who's the oldest man hosting a game show, Savannah?
The Price is Right?
The Price is Right. You win. You are a big...
I got
you
it?
You are a big winner, Savannah. Way to go. Savannah, do you have big, beautiful breasts, Savannah?
I've had... Third, I'm a 36 double D over here.
36 double D.
Yes.
Wonderful. I'm wearing Depend undergarments, Savannah. What are you wearing, Savannah? Tell Bob. Did you do me a favor? Tell Bob right now what you are wearing, Savannah.
Right now I've got on a little red G-string.
Just the G-string, no pantaloons?
No pantaloons, just a G-string.
And what about the top, Savannah?
I got on just a little white tank top with no bra underneath it today.
No bra? Do you have wonderful nipples?
They're very extremely hard right now, I can't lie.
Oh, my, Savannah, we're having a good time. And what is the show that I host on CBS Television?
Yeah, on The Price is Right.
The Price is Right. Now, Savannah, may I talk to you for a moment?
Sure.
What we did was we talked to another one of your girlfriends named Halle. She did not get this question correct, but you'll win a big prize from Bob if you do. Are you ready, Savannah?
I'm ready.
Please tell me, Bob, the name of my announcer on The Price is Right.
That's Bob Barker.
No, he is my announcer. He wears flamboyant, wild, gay jackets. Can you tell me what his name is, Savannah?
That I don't know.
His name is Rod Rodney, and he's in Thailand right now with little boys walking over his nude back.
Oh, really?
Has there been any other game show hosts that have ever...
Have there been... Savannah!
What?
Are you there?
I'm here.
Have there been any other game show hosts that have called you Savannah?
No, never.
Am I the first major television personality to call you Savannah?
You are the first.
Wonderful. Now, let's get down to the most important question we have for Savannah.
Okay.
Tell me about your feet.
Well, I'm a 6 1/2.
Oh, smaller than an 8. That's lovely. Do you have a toe ring, Savannah?
Yes, I do.
Bob is close to completion.
Really?
Keep talking about those toes and those feet right now, Savannah. You're helping Bob. Bob is doing wonderfully with this foot discussion.
I've got a little red toenail polish on right now.
Yes, Savannah. Bob has completed. Fantastic. You are wonderful. And I didn't even get your hair color, Savannah.
I know you didn't. I'm a blondie.
Oh, I love blonde. Savannah, can I ask you, did you see The Price is Right $1 million primetime spectacular on CBS Television?
No, I didn't see it.
I just won both showcases, Savannah.
Gee, has it come on here yet in California?
Savannah, I've got a very important question. This is from me. Who are you talking to?
You're not Bob.
I'm Bob Barker.
You are?
I am, and do you spay and neuter your pet, Savannah?
Yes, I'm good at doing that.
Wonderful, Savannah, with the big nipples. You are a big winner on The Price is Right. Thank you, Savannah.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Bob.
I will call you soon, Savannah. You've been a wonderful
That's
contestant.
Hold on to
when am I
going to
win?
Can you hold on just a minute?
Oh, yeah, I can.
I'll talk to you as soon as we do this.
Oh. Hold on. Now, I'll pretend to be... I'd love doing this the Rob thing one time.
Very good. Let's
say that I'm your secretary.
Why don't you do that? Get on with Savannah, and she's got Bob's big nipples.
Yes, hello. I'm Mr. Barker's assistant. Can I help you? Is this another... is this a phone sex line? A phone action line.
Phone action.
Was it Mr. Barker who called you? Yes, it is Bob Barker. We've had a problem. We've had a problem with Bob calling these numbers from the set here at CBS.
Oh, Don!
Yes, Bob.
Don, put her back on the line. I love Savannah.
Wonderful. Blinko check.
All I can do is ask that you keep this conversation with television's Bob Barker private. We would hate for any of this to get out, and I would love to
ask
you...
Ask her about her nipples. Ask her about Bob Barker's nipples.
Can you hear him?
Showcase, showdown. Savannah, I love your nipples. Wow. Bob Barker loves Savannah's nipples.
What I would love to do is get your address.
Make sure she sprays and neuters her pets. All those girls on the sex lines have cats.
My name is Les Moonves. Lester Moonves.
Tell her. I want you to tell Savannah that little Bob is ready for the second half of The Price is Right. Little Bob wants to come out and play.
We've had real problems with Mr. Barker.
No problem.
I am serious.
I discovered V-I-A-G-R-A, Viagra. Bob Barker's blue. Little blue pill.
He's been a very bad boy.
What I would like to do is send you
a nice bag that has a CBS shirt in it.
Let's play flip-flop.
Maybe some tickets to an upcoming... are you in Southern California?
Tell her I want to play with my putter.
Yeah,
The Price is Right.
Send you to see one of our shows, Yes Dear, or maybe The King of Queens.
I will give her a hole in one.
Great, if you hold on just a second, we'll get your information. And again, please, no matter what happens, under no circumstances, did Bob Barker ever call?
The actual retail price without going over? Let's play freeze frame.
Thank you very
little
much.
Little Bob's ready. And hut. Look at little Bob coming out of his suit. Bob's coming out of his suit to play with Savannah. Wonderful, Don. I enjoy that. I really do. Would you like to play ring toss while little Bob is at attention?
Oh, God. Bye, Bob.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Wonderful.
It's nuts.
All right, now the best was that broad. She hears you in the background
screaming.
And she says, oh, my God, that really is Bob Barker.
World
and I say, yeah.
Radio was strictly forbidden. She's one that. Man found a way to bring good news to his people.
Buzz.
He made it up.
She says, you know, I didn't know at first, but it really is him. And I said, yeah, we've had a problem with him calling all these numbers all the time. Is there any way that you can keep this quiet? She says, I promise.
Yeah.
I won't tell anybody that Bob Barker calls. Meanwhile.
We'll have to call her back.
You're screaming about her nipples. And as a matter of fact, she's still on hold.
Really?
Hi, is this the... this is Lester Moonves again.
Savannah.
Hi, and your first name was? Savannah.
I want her! I want her, I'm Bob Barker.
I'm having a big problem with Bob. Hold on,
Bob
please.
Wants to play Plinko with little Bob.
We'd love to send you some gifts. Hold on.
Little Bob has white hair also.
Hey, Joe or somebody, send that whore something.
Help her out.
Let's do send her something that this says CBS on it. I mean, we do have... Pardon?
Hello?
Stinky Poon.
Hey. But he said Stinky Poon for Joe.
Hey, Joey.
Play it straight.
Hi, Bob.
Hello, Joe Ottinger.
Joe. Joey, play it straight. Tell
what
the
can
girl
I do
you,
for you?
Tell the girl you work for CBS. Send her some prize. And make sure you send it out in a CBS envelope.
Oh, Joe.
Play it straight.
Bob.
Joe, what is your favorite game show?
Price is Right.
The Price is Right. We have a prize for
Joe.
Joey.
Oh, thank you, Joe. Buzz?
Yes.
What is your lead story tonight?
Today, Michael Jackson says he was betrayed by the makers of tonight's TV special.
Yeah.
He's a fruit.
And by Channel 7 last night.
Wonderful.
Stay tuned, everybody.
That's ABC.
It's uncued.
That's right.
Uncued.
You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that someone has gone through and played with our cartridges.
It seems they're very fun to play with.
I know they are.
That's why we have to do this.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Bob. Well, anyway, you know, stay tuned. That was very
professional.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
What's the word from Planet Crackpot?
The Don and Mike Show.
Two tumbling, tumbling dickweeds. Don Geronimo and Michael Mara.
Let me tell you, tomorrow on the show, in-studio mystery guest.
Ooh.
We're going to blindfold Mike and blindfold Buzz. You don't know who it is, right, Buzz?
I don't know.
I know Mike doesn't know either.
Right.
They will either harmonize their he or she's voice,
right,
or make he or she use a fake voice.
Cool.
Plus, tomorrow, we'll be screaming about the weather.
Yes.
No matter what happens.
Right.
Buzz totally wrecked my plans.
So be ready, whether you're listening to us in Richmond, D.C., Baltimore, Philadelphia, or as far east as Pittsburgh.
Amen.
We're going to use the opening break tomorrow to scream about that.
Good.
Plus, we'll have our first tribute to Black History Month.
Good.
With Robert the Angry Mailman.
He's a lightning rod.
And also a brand new low-budget Jeff R.D. All of that tomorrow. Now it's time for Buzz. Brought to you by Veranax Sexual Enhancer. Have great sex more often with Veranax. Find food stores, health food stores, pharmacies, and retailers everywhere. Or call 1-888-TRY-VMAX. And now here is Buzz.
Hi, Donna Mike. Michael Jackson says tonight's show about him is unfair. Quoting Michael, I trusted Martin Bashir to come into my life because I wanted the truth to be told. Martin persuaded me to trust him, that his would be an honest and fair portrayal.
Here is the problem, Buzz.
Yes?
The problem is, if you've seen Access Hollywood, Entertainment
right.
Tonight,
yeah.
Today,
oh, yeah.
Good Morning America,
uh-huh.
You've already seen the best parts of the show.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna TiVo CSI.
And that tonight, right, I mean, you've got, I know, Frida will want to watch Friends,
mm-hmm.
and Will and Gay, and what's the show in between those two that I never watched?
Scrubs. A good show.
Right. I'll watch CSI.
Right.
Mm-hmm. There will be an NBA game on that I'll watch.
Right.
I will not watch the Michael Jackson thing. But
I will not
for
either.
You. Because I know I've already seen the best part.
You have.
Absolutely. With him, with the kid with the mask.
With the kids with the, yeah, with the weird Halloween masks
yeah.
on.
Dangling the kid, which they show.
There's anyway,
nothing new in the show tonight.
ABC made three tactical mistakes.
Okay.
First, they interviewed us.
Right.
Second, they gave out too many clips
mm-hmm.
to get hype, and now they've got no show left to show.
Right.
And third, they're showing it tonight when there's good stuff on the other channels.
Right.
When if they saved it for tomorrow night,
they'd get a bigger rating.
They'd kill.
Yeah.
Because even if you'd seen it tomorrow night,
right.
I mean, what's on Friday night?
Nothing.
Right. Hack?
Mm-hmm.
Hack?
Fast lane.
Yeah.
Fast lane? Right.
That's it.
Anyway.
America's Funniest Home Videos.
But that's on ABC.
Can't we watch both?
Continuing Michael's quote, today I feel more betrayed than ever that someone who got to know my children, my staff, and me, who I let into my heart and told the truth, could then sacrifice the trust and produce this terrible, unfair program.
Fast play.
Everyone who knows me will know I would never harm any child. And
fast
by the way,
play.
Michael has now filed a formal complaint. They have places you can do this in Great Britain about the special which aired there Monday night. In the special, Michael admits he sleeps with kids.
Oh, boy.
After the show aired in Britain, the press there said his career was over, but sales of his Thriller album there are up 500% since the show, and his History album up by 1,000%.
He filed with the PB, Pedophile Bureau.
Now, can people find true love on television? Probably not, but it entertains the masses for them to try. The banker who was ABC's second bachelor now says the wedding is off.
28-year-old Aaron Burge of Springfield, Missouri, proposed to Helen S. Eskeritz at the end of the second season of that reality show. In fact, he insisted on buying the ring himself, turning down the one supplied by the show's producers.
Click, click, click.
But now he tells People magazine it was over by New Year's.
There you go.
He'll explain what went wrong and what's happened with the ring on an ABC special February 20th.
Oh, I know. Come on.
He says there was no infidelity and that the breakup was not ugly. He says they still email
one another. He'll explain it on an ABC
special. Of course, because they have nothing else.
There you go.
The group, fronted by the late Jim Morrison, The Doors, is back together and touring 30 years after the lead singer's death.
What was it, Robbie Tonight Show?
Yeah. Horrible.
Were they on?
Rob hit me this. He says, hey, The Doors are going to be on Leno.
Hmm.
Now, I never watched Leno. I'm never up late enough to watch Letterman, but I always TiVo Letterman.
Right.
So for this one night, I TiVo'd the West Coast feed of Leno.
Very good.
So I could get both shows.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's the other three douchebags without Jim Morrison.
They got a guy subbing for Jim Morrison?
Yeah, but it's like one of the Backstreet Boys.
Make it the other two. Keyboardist Ray Manzarek and guitarist Robbie Krieger were part of the original band, but Morrison's dead, and they've replaced drummer John Densmore with Stuart Copeland from The Police.
I didn't even notice.
Ian Artsberry, who even looks like Jim Morrison, is the new lead singer, but it's not the same group. It even has a new name, The Doors 21st Century. Manzarek says former drummer John Densmore is cool with this. Quoting Ray, John's got bad ears and can't play loud stuff, so John said, fine, go ahead. But John is not fine with this. In fact, he's now suing the group for going on without him. At the very least, he wants a cut of the money.
Yeah.
You want to hear classic Doors, really?
Yeah.
If you're a Door fan?
Yeah, I love it. The Door.
He was a poet.
It was great. He was naked when he did that.
Yeah.
He pulled out his thing, took a leak on stage. Then he went and he wrote this song.
The Door.
Fun facts to know and tell. A month before record producer Phil Spector was arrested for murder, the man known as the British Phil Spector was part of a murder-suicide case. That was also a month ago that the real Phil Spector, the American one, told a British newspaper that he has devils and was probably insane.
Oh, no.
Quoting him, I take medication for schizophrenia, but I wouldn't say I'm schizophrenic. I have a bipolar personality. I'm my own worst enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, the Phil Spector mix. Continuing the quote from him, Phil Spector, I have not been well enough to function as part of society, so I chose not to. I can't stand to be talked to. I can't stand to be looked at. People idolize me, but I tell them, you don't want my life because it has not been a pleasant life. I've been a very tortured soul.
It's like you're reading my mind.
Sorry about that.
Don't look at me.
I don't remember.
It's also in England where Madonna has filed a formal complaint about a magazine that claimed she's pregnant. They have a press watchdog group over there called the Press Complaints Commission. The magazine is called Heat, and in her complaint, Madonna says their report was inaccurate. Heat reported that Madonna had visited a birth specialist in London at the end of last year. The magazine pointed out her baggy clothing and that she'd stopped dyeing her hair the way some pregnant women do.
Her baggy uterus.
The complaint commission says it'll talk to the publishers. The publishers have no comment.
Her baggy meat curtains. Yee!
Like a lot of other 44-year-olds, the material girl now needs and uses reading glasses.
Hold on there, Buzz. All right. We will be... Did you say reading glasses?
Reading glasses.
It's a weeding glass.
Those are mine.
We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Gosh, I hate to interrupt. It's all been so incredibly fascinating and entertaining and instructive. Really, the time has just flown by.
The Don and Mike Show.
They take the tongue boat to Tuna Town. Don and Mike.
Well, Joey Ardinger has just informed me of two things. First... Oh, hold on. Buds, I won't take up much of your time, I promise. Hi, Joey. Tell us about the conversation with the phone whore. Remember? Joe, do you remember the conversation with the phone whore?
Yes, I do.
Okay, tell us what happened.
I picked up and I said, all right, well, I need your address so I can send you the prize. And she said, well, that's just the problem. We can't give out our phone numbers or our addresses when we're doing this job.
Right. Yeah.
And I said, well, then I guess I can't really send you anything. And she goes, that's okay, but don't worry. I won't tell anybody about Pop Barker.
That's great. And the other update from
Joe
is a weather update, Joe.
Yes, the snow has just moved into Fairfax City.
Whoa!
Wow.
So somebody better tell Ron and Fez they have two options.
Yes.
Either they get out of here at 11:35 and hope and pray that there is a 12:15 or 12:30 train back to New York, or they will be here tomorrow night.
That's right.
Because they have never been in Washington, D.C.
They don't know.
The morning of a snowstorm.
Panic!
Which is like an S storm.
Yeah, it's not good.
So get used to it.
Absolutely.
I mean, get ready to get used to it.
Absolutely.
And I'm going to plan on seeing them tomorrow night.
Yes.
I'll put them up.
They can stay at Buzz's house.
I can't imagine them actually getting up, getting to the train station tomorrow through no fault of their own.
Of course
it's just
not. No.
They don't know how the city operates.
Right. It's supposed to be a bit sloppy tomorrow.
Right. And I keep wanting to throw Matt and Huggy in there, too.
Rob's calling. Hey, you know, let's all do it. Rob's calling for 10 inches. How many you say?
3.
Buzz.
I'll say 4.5.
And I will go with my usual 2 feet.
And anyway, I'm sure Matt and Huggy will have no problem making it to WYSB because they work here every night.
And they live there.
They're used to it.
And they actually live in the building.
They live in Philadelphia.
They actually rent out one of the TV studios.
And it is my wish that Grant Napier gets run over by a car or struck by lightning.
Right.
Something happens. I know there's no snow out in Sacramento.
Gramps Napier.
Yes,
Napier. Grandpa Napier.
Yeah. I'd like you to use that phrase more often. It is my wish.
It would please me greatly.
I do hope indeed that happens.
If Gramps Napier was struck by lightning tonight.
Indeed.
There, I've covered all the shows that follow us.
Wonderful.
Very good.
You'd think the Olympics was another Joe Millionaire as much time as NBC's planning to give it. The network says it will telecast an incredible 806 hours of the 2004 games in segments that will literally air in all 24 of the day's hours.
BFD.
The 800, well, I agree, but this is incredible.
Well, I know, I'm not shooting the messenger
here. No, I know that, but it's amazing. 806 hours, nearly double the length of the 2000 games, and that was nearly 4 times the length of the broadcast from the year before.
Summer or winter?
We're talking about winter games down here that we're comparing.
But nobody watches them. The last one that I could remember anybody really watching was the one where Lionel Richie sang the National Anthem.
I didn't even watch that, and I'm the only one that watches the
Olympics. But 1984, maybe.
The 806 hours includes all the hours that will air on NBC-owned Telemundo and its other networks, Bravo, CNBC, and MSNBC.
Hey, that's a mighty impressive roster of stations.
It sure is.
NBC, I love me that luge.
NBC made $75 million profit on the 2002 Winter Games. Some of the extra hours in the next Olympics will be devoted to badminton and table tennis.
Yeah, my sport didn't get in.
What's that?
Snow writing.
Oh, gotcha.
Someday.
Yeah. Cursive?
Yeah, cursive. Of course, cursive. Yeah, you gotta go with cursive. Printing was just too difficult.
Printing is more of a bladder control.
Absolutely.
Start,
right. Junior and senior division.
What color ink do you use?
Yellow.
Not red.
No. I eat asparagus before I do it.
Well, what about brown ink?
Brown ink is, that's only for the exclamation point at the end.
That's impossible. That would be almost impossible to write.
Block letters.
I mean, unless you had, like, diarrhea.
Right? Yeah, well, that's kind of like you're a human Sharpie.
In sports, it'll be one more go-round for racing cousins from the Andretti family.
Hey, wouldn't that be great, though, in the wintertime someone says, hey, you're Don from the Don and Mike show?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Can I have your autograph? Sure. You pull down your pants, you go...
Wow, a perfect salutation.
Can I get one for my sister? The Andretti family. John Andretti's been given permission by his NASCAR team, Petty Enterprises, to race in the Indy 500 a last time against cousin Michael Andretti. Michael says he's retiring after that race.
Michael.
And 14-year Major League veteran David Justice tells ESPN he's retiring as a player. Finally...
Oh, you know what I say, Buzz? Justice for all.
Yay! Finally, all those supersized orders of French fries have led to the need for a supersized ambulance for the morbidly obese.
Oh.
Ambulance maker American Medical Response is unveiling a model that can carry patients who weigh as much as a half ton. The Oregonian newspaper says the vehicle has more room.
Did you ever suck the jelly out of a jelly donut and then fill it with chocolate swirl ice cream?
It has a wide cot instead of a narrow gurney and a special winch for lifting.
Sounds to me like the next WJFK station van.
I'm Buzz Burbank on the Don and Mike Show.
Thank you, Buzzy.
No!
That's it. Gotta go.
Gotta go. Gotta go to the snow.
Gotta go unless we're all crazy snowed in tomorrow.
Yeah, absolutely. And we'll have cocoa.
That's it. See you for a new episode tomorrow. Good day to you, sir.
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 Va, 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 va.
Oh, darling.
Va, 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 va.
Yes, va, va,
va. Va, 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 va. Who's
got your chin?
Right. Hold on. Oh, what am I doing here?
You're playing the guy with the ice cream.
Right. There you go. Okay, right.
DM.
Peters.
Till we meet again. This is Sammy Davis Jr. saying, be kind, be nice, and I hope the next performer has the pleasure of having as nice an audience as you've been tonight. And let me leave you swinging.